recap, you can recite them.
All right, the world is watching. Go for it.
Pressure. No pressure at all. All right.
No pressure. My two followers are watching you.
That's still too many.
What?
Yeah, I think Bob has actually made it tonight, so Jim and Bob are watching.
Oh, all right. All right. Second of winter, 9 a.m. A tribe is separate in the city, doing their own odds and ends. Then at the end of the day, we all meet back at our lodgings for a good night's rest. In the morning, Anna Kate informs us that a close friend and ally came to her room in the midst of the night and told her assassins. What? I have an echo.
I hear a little bit of an echo.
I thought someone was talking because of the echo.
Oh, yeah. Kill your mic, maybe.
Wait, who's echoing? Go ahead and read, and I'll see if anyone's echoing.
Anna Kate's ally came to her in the midst of the night and told her assassins were after her and us. But it did not deter us from our regular business. We had previously planned to follow up on an invitation to see an archmage, so we set off as a group to go to the tower. After arriving, we were introduced to the archmage, Korik Symphony of the Phoenix Guild, and he nonchalantly showed us his power by just magically serving us rather delightful drinks. His casual use of magic was truly astonishing. My friends are powerful, but I don't know if we compare. He then tells us that he's impressed with us and what the tribe has accomplished, and that he's been keeping an eye on us magically, which I don't like to hear, but after talking, we do believe he's on our side and that we somewhat trust him.
He's still hearing the echo?
No, it's gone now.
Okay, go ahead, sorry.
At least we have some of the same long-term goals, and for an exchange of information, he offers us help from the Phoenix Guild, which is appreciated. He seems to be pretty straightforward. At least my betters seem to think so. He does seem extremely interested in our newest companion, Zala, though, which I don't blame him. He's an interesting person and comes from an interesting place. But after his inquiry with Zala, we part ways, and I do believe we've made a new strong ally to aid us in our fight against the Shadow Lords. We then split up to go about our business again, and Beryl's friend Daniel, I'm going to mess up this last name, Caver?
Kavara.
Kavara. Daniel Kavara meets with her, and she sets him on a little shopping spree for the tribe. He acquires some new trinkets for the tribe, which was much appreciated. All while the more book-learned members of the tribe managed to uncover some new information to guide us through our next objective. Then later that evening, the guards show up looking for Anna Kate, and apparently she is quite the criminal. We later learn that she escaped the city.
Alleged criminal.
We follow suit after trying to clear her name. Sim really is great at strategy and politics. He could outthink even the most brilliant of minds. I would be nervous to be on his bad side. Anyways, we set out to rejoin our friend. I've got to say, I love all of the tribe, but I think Anna Kate is probably the one who leads to having the most fun. And that's it.
All right. So yeah, there was some hijinks, and the group left meeting up with Anna Kate outside of Tyvanus, as apparently she is wanted now by one of the more prominent families. Was it the Blackwaters that were looking for you?
Yes, indeed, it is. Yes.
Yeah. All right. So those people. So it is the 6th of winter, probably about 10:30 in the AM at this point. You are all north of Tyvanus, and I wasn't sure what the group was planning to do next.
The Zorik or Itzik?
Itzik, the city?
Yeah, we're going to teleport somewhere.
True.
I should get into accent. So we were going to teleport somewhere. We're doing Isik or the Vorik, or are we traveling in the trees? Like, what are we doing?
Why would we be?
We've done all this research. So
why would we be going to Isik? Like, that would have been to go back and talk to somebody there, I assume. I didn't remember that piece.
I didn't know if there was a thing that we had to do before we attempted to go into the mountains and die.
I think you are going to head to Dazoric to look for a guide to take you into the mountains.
I usually leave myself whispered notes in the chat, like at the end of a session, so I remember what the heck I was thinking when we cut it off, but I have nothing for myself right now.
unless one of us knows a way to the teleportation circle closer to our destination, I believe the fastest way to get to Dazoric might actually be to take 2 days and do some interplanar travel.
Well, there you go.
Remind me where this group is.
We're just right outside Tyvannis, a little bit.
Oh, we're at Tyvannis. Okay, all right. Sorry, I'm like looking around the map. Okay, we just left the city. Okay, gotcha.
Indeed, but although I cannot freely teleport throughout Gaian, what I can do is I can take us via plane shifting to the Shadowfell and thence to our sanctuary, and from there it is easy enough to plane shift back to Gaian, and there is perhaps some small chance of misfortune, but I can cover great distances this way, as I merely need to know my destination.
Wait, hold on. Small chance of misfortune? Like, how small a chance of misfortune? Like, just checking for instance.
I consider it to be negligible.
So you would, when bring tribe back to Gaian, would be in different place?
Indeed.
Closer to tribe goal?
Indeed. Planar travel is in many ways more flexible than teleportation.
Do we have to go to Issyk for any reason? I don't think so, right?
Not unless need to talk to Chiron, because Chiron was building stuff for tribe.
But it has not been enough time for significant progress to have been.
Oh shit!
There.
I just realized I forgot to get Chiron his romance novels. God dang it!
Can we retcon that?
You're outside city now. If we had way to contact Crimson Blade, we could presumably send a package along with what we have, dispatched. But I do not think it is a good idea now to enter city again. So
No.
Chiron is a creature of great patience. He waited for literal decades alone in his library, I believe.
100 years.
Everyone, keep your eyes out when we go to old ancient libraries full of horrible things. Keep an eye out for the romance section. That's all I'm saying.
I do believe Chiron would appreciate the irony of ancient preserved text bearing lurid entertainment.
So
at fair minimum, it gives
actually,
me
yeah, there's
the
illuminated
library.
Manuscripts like that in a lot of cultures.
Yeah, the Kama Sutra.
The saucy section of the ancient arcana.
So now, instead of looking for pictures in the pages, Beryl will just look at the covers and see if there's a shirtless guy and like a maiden flowing hair.
Yeah.
Riding a horse.
Has to be riding a horse.
If there is no faster plan and no other thing to do, then I believe the.
Hold on. Beryl, traveling to the trees requires you know the tree you're traveling to, yes?
Yes. Now that Beryl
dang it.
Yeah, now that Beryl has been to Issyk and to Char and to Capital, Beryl knows trees there, but Beryl doesn't know trees in Dazoric.
Indeed.
All right. All right. I'm holding someone's hand, is all I'm saying. So
sounds exciting. I am all for this.
Holding my hand? Okay, I will hold.
No.
Hand.
Well. No, I mean the teleporting thing, but sure, I'll hold your hand. And Kate kind of looks you up and down, like, not bad.
Meh.
All right. He's no Titus.
Blue.
He's no Titus, but he's okay.
But before we teleport.
Yes.
How many are we? There are six of us, and then there is the Wyvern, and then there is I suppose we should ask.
We have that follower.
We have the trainer.
Is the trainer willing to travel at least briefly to other plane? I can assure you safety.
Who is this?
Who's our follower?
The ranger that barrel.
Oh. Do we have his name?
I think he thought we were going to the town in the north to find the Hunter's Guild to hire someone more permanently. So I don't think he signed up for interplanar travel. But...
Yeah, but I mean, it's interplanar travel. It's bringing us back to our destination. We're just saving the walking.
Okay.
We don't have to tell him that we're leaving the plane. We could just say we're going to going to our castle, and then we're teleporting back. He doesn't know. He need to know.
I can't plane shift directly to the sanctuary. I have to plane shift to Aldrin's Watch first. The castle full of Shadarkai would sort of be a giveaway.
Well, it's a secret place where we're going, so we're going to blindfold you so you don't know the way there. Uh-huh. Problem solved.
It's often wise to lie to employees.
Yeah, no, I'm telling the guy the truth because, like, if he doesn't want to go, we'll figure it out.
If Tribe is definitely coming back and heading for Daybreak soon, then maybe Wyvern and Ranger could start toward Daybreak now and meet Tribe there. But no, because it'll take him much, much longer to get there. Weeks, right?
Yeah, so...
Oh, okay, never mind. That's bad.
I'll say his name is Gajira. What are those cat people called?
Tabaxi.
Yeah, he is a Tabaxi ranger. You will say, I have not stepped through the veil, but I've heard stories of it being very dangerous. I would prefer travel along the paths. That sort of danger I know much better. What NPCs do you have with you right now?
I think now that's the only one.
Just Gajira?
Yeah.
I think that's it.
I thought Ufri came with us.
No, Ufri's hanging out with Corvin in the pilot thing.
Yep.
Oh, okay.
Okay, and Shock and Melody, I believe, stayed in Tyvanus, right?
Actually, they stayed in...
Are they in Char?
Shock is still recovering. I think he's on his feet and stuff now, but he was recovering from the shadow sickness. And Melody, I marked her as restarting her healing shop once we got back to Char on the...
Okay, so I'll put them in Char. Yeah. I still had them in your background, but that makes sense. Alright, so Ufri is back in Shadowfell. I also had her in...
Alira in Tyvanus, because we still have her in Char. But then we encountered her.
Yeah, she should still be in Tyvanus. Alright, so, yeah, Gajira says, I would prefer to avoid leaving the plane of Gaian, as it's not something I've done before. Is it safe to travel through planes so fickly? I don't even know if that's a word.
It is. Most of the danger of planar travel comes largely from not knowing your destination. The first, you don't know where you will come.
Oh.
But this destination, it is a stronghold held by our allies. And then from there, one held only by us that even our allies cannot breach. And then coming straight back to Gaian.
Give me a persuasion check.
And you gotta try Vlad's cooking when he's in his own kitchen.
That is true. It is something worth trying.
Since I've heard many stories of your group, you seem like you've accomplished much. Yeah, give me a persuasion check.
Sorry, I'm having a little trouble with my sheep.
There you go. Oh, wow.
So he hesitates, but says, if you say it is safe, I will trust your word.
Ah, excellent. So, let's see, 6, and then 1, 2, okay.
And Vlad is specifically not saying shit right now.
If you're nervous, you can hold Vlad's hand. I'm sure he'd appreciate it.
yes, I would. Yes, if you don't mind, we will do this together.
P just says, sure.
It is, ironic, but, then pulls out the tuning fork and says, This spell is actually faster to cast than the teleportation that I've used to get around in Gaian. And whoosh.
Alright, go ahead and link the spell that all you're right. casting.
Literal whoosh. Now remember, don't roll low.
No. this one I believe doesn't have a roll. It's just the one thing I can do today.
Alright. And you're attempting to teleport to... Or plane shift to your...
The teleportation circle in Aldrin's watch, because I only have a tuning fork for the Shadowfell. I don't have one for the Void yet.
Okay. Look! We have to hold hands!
Yep.
Oh, okay.
So, technically... I mean, it's not a big deal. Technically, your stronghold isn't in the Shadowfell. It's in a pocket dimension.
No, that's why I say we have to go to Aldrin's Watch.
We're going to okay.
Circle in Aldrin's Watch.
Gotcha. All right, I misheard
we're doing,
you then.
We're doing research on how to get directly there, I think.
They were trying to get directly there,
all I need to do is make a focus attune to that little plane.
Right. Which, because we have a circle in the Twilight Sanctum.
I'm trying to do is, yes, get more circles attached to that network. Right. Lou said it's just a ritual that has a time and
you
haven't specified yet.
So yeah, you cast your spell. Go ahead, describe what you do.
I mean, Sim just holds the tuning fork up with one hand and grabs someone, whoever's at the end of the daisy chain of people in the other, and... just mutters and gestures and sort of looks around as though he's thinking about something, and when he looks down, you're all somewhere else.
Yeah, so shadow encompasses you as if the world suddenly changed around you, as you are standing in a familiar spot. The Shadowfell teleportation circle, to be exact.
Okay. We're here, right? Yeah.
Whoops.
I forgot how dark.
Wrong level.
Floor.
Yeah, wrong floor. Wonk.
I can see why you get confused, though.
Yay!
So,
they have guards posted now?
There are a couple of guards sitting there playing poker who immediately would jump up and go for their weapons, but then they see it's just you all and kind of sigh with relief. They say, welcome back, tribe.
Indeed. You have my apologies, but we are not staying long, and you are likely to see us pass through casually this way more often in future. We are going to use this somewhat as way station for our travels. Is there any urgent news for us?
No, things have been quiet. You are the only ones who have used the teleportation circle, but we were told that we should keep an eye out just in case someone else had the information that we didn't know about.
Wonderful. In that case, send my regards to Sivil, and let him know I will be checking in by sending at some point soon. And then I'll just activate the circle to take us to the sanctuary.
Alright, am I echoing? I feel like I'm echoing.
I'm hearing some background noise occasionally, but I don't know who it's coming from. I don't think it's an echo, because I thought I heard a woman's voice, and it wasn't mine.
Okay.
Yeah, I actually thought it was you talking to someone else, because I heard a woman's voice.
Yeah, I heard it, and I'm like, since I'm the only woman in this chat, they're all going to think it's me.
All right. Well, I'll just, let me know if I'm echoing. It's weird. Maybe, I thought I, anyway, yeah. Let me know if anyone's lighting up besides who's talking. Oh, it might be Xalophane. I think I just saw it there.
Oh, interesting.
I saw him light up while I was talking.
Yeah, he's giving off a light every time.
Oh, yeah, he might be on. Yeah, I think every one of us talks, it seems to be.
Okay,
yeah.
Let me see. Is it doing something weird?
We just see it lighting up green. Yeah, there's not always any noise from it.
I am hearing my voice in the background a little bit when I'm talking. So I think it's echoing. It's not loud, it's just very slight.
I mean, Discord normally does noise cancellation from its output and input, but you had output input issues just now. Oh, you have headphones on? What is this then? Yeah.
No, that happens to me too sometimes. It's weird. Like, even though I have headphones on, it'll just echo.
Can you remind me who is Alice Kirik? Alice?
Let me take a look at my notes.
Sorry, it was just, it's one of the NPCs under Aldrin's watch, and I just couldn't remember who it was. It looks like a white-haired, violet-eyed man.
Let's see, in the Shadowfell. Elias, who are you?
That is the picture I associated with the guy we still haven't let out of our
mind. He's not
in Aldrin's watch anymore. He's in the sanctuary.
Yeah, we moved the mirror. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, that poor guy.
So I think he's still imprisoned.
Sure is.
Yeah.
Along with the demon and the fake ? Hollow hand.
Yeah. Before we teleport out of this room, there's some questions to be answered.
Poker. Just be like, a poker? Oh, pocket aces? Nice hand, man. See you later.
And they just sort of look at you, and the guy goes, son of a...
No, the guy's probably only got, like, jack high, and so you just bluff for him.
Right. Yeah, the guards just will kind of nod and say, we'll keep an eye out for you. But if anyone else tries to come through, we will let you know.
Wonderful.
And the one guy says, don't tell them my hand. He's a little bit annoyed.
Yeah, trust me, Titus, they don't like that. I learned that the hard way.
All right, so you don't actually have to move around this place like with the party token, but what do you want to do here?
I mean, we're just going to activate. This circle is hooked into the network, I believe.
Yeah.
It leads to the Twilight's Edge, so we're just going to activate it and head out.
Go to the Twilight to your home base.
Yep.
Okay. So
change the map again.
So you step through, returning to the Twilight Sanctuary, which Gajira is just amazed by all this. He says, "How type of magic lets you just move around so quickly?"
To be honest, this is not magic of our making. We merely found it and were granted access. That is largely the case for most powerful things you will see.
He says, I spent many years training on moving through the wilds. I guess I should have been learning how to magically just teleport places.
It takes a long time.
It's not that great, really. Not that great. No, it's fine.
He just nods. So yeah, what do you want to do? You are back at your base.
Oh, we have one day.
Indeed, we have a day to spend before I am capable of traveling planes again. So, and then I can take us, I guess, Beryl, would it be better for us to go to the Zorik or to Daybreak? I don't know.
Beryl wants to hire, we were going to get permanent trainer from Hunter's Guild in Daybreak. Gazira? Am I saying that right? Gazira only agreed to go with us to Daybreak.
Well, then it would be rude to do anything else. And if it is, with teleportation, we are still saving weeks of time. So
yeah, at least, what, 3 or 4 weeks?
Indeed, and perhaps in Daybreak we can learn more of what is in mountains. Perhaps being somewhat closer, there will be people there who can tell us more about where we are headed.
Well, I'm happy to train your wyvern for the day, Beryl.
Yes.
Beryl, while I'm here. Do you have some place that's safe for me to keep the creature where I can train it in private?
Privacy.
How much space do you need?
There's a big audience chamber. It's got some pews and stuff in the way.
He says, not much. I just need there to not be too many people around, as the creature will get distracted easily at this age.
What about the sparring room? What about sparring room next to Forges?
He says, certainly.
There was an armory there, but yes.
Was it an armory? I just saw the target.
Yeah, when
I
was armory. Sparring. Fine.
All right, so you send him over there to train the wyvern. What about the rest of you? What do you want to do today? Just downtime?
Yeah, quickie downtime, I think.
All right.
Most of you just wanted to get Anakate beyond the reach of any law.
Yeah, get her someplace safe.
I don't know what you're worried about. Uh-huh. I had everything under control.
Indeed, right. But how long would that remain true, Anakate? You would likely go... My understanding is, if you have no troubles to... if there are no trouble knocking at your door, you will go find more. And I believe you will have trouble finding more here. So.
Yes, this place is incredibly boring. Thanks.
It is my greatest place. Okay.
Anyone need anything carved out of wood? Because that's all I can do here.
You can make a decorative cutting board for me. There you go.
You could try to prank some angels.
Are those angels still around?
I believe there is likely to be one or two still here. Do not meddle with them. That is...
I was going to ask her to train with me.
Ah.
Oh, there you go.
Let's see. Who do we have here? We have Raylus, Elias, Xerxes, Yali was here, and Corvin is here, I believe.
And Ufri?
Well, his, yeah. His...
Yeah, Ufri's here, yeah.
Right, we never actually went and questioned him.
What's left of Raylus? Well, like, I mean, Raylus without Gaiva.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, and Ufri.
I'm gonna
Was there anyone else here that I'm not thinking of?
I don't remember who Ufri is either.
The hunter, the guy we saved. Or the Midnight Pyre.
Yeah,
from the mummy lair.
Oh, that's right, gotcha, okay.
Yeah, he said he'd join you guys, because he was
the
thankful.
The NPC info sheet says he's cleaning, question mark?
Yes.
I guess we'll put that in there, didn't know what he was actually doing here at the Twilight Sanctuary.
He was just hanging out for the time being.
He was like, gotcha. Well, what am I going to do? Like, did you clean?
All right.
Lou, I will try to communicate with Shadow Strider again and find out what's her name did when she had Shadow Strider that kept me from being able to use it and kept me from being attuned to it in the fight where I died. Surely she did something to this sword that was worth it.
So. Are you talking about
Tealam took the
sword. Tealam, that's right.
Something cool to it.
Yeah, she was gonna unlock more of it, and then she brought it back right before the fight, but it wasn't time for me to attune to it. So I couldn't, you know, teleport out of the aura that ended up being my
demise. Doom.
Yeah.
So the sword will say, so what did you ask it? What's changed about it?
Yes. So is there anything new that you can do now?
What did it do before?
It was +2. It allowed me to shadow step 3 times a day. And then it did that nifty plane shifting that got us to the Shadowfell in the first place.
Right, we were told that was a one-off, but it did seem to be able to detect planar weaknesses as well, which I don't know if that was a
one-off. So it says I can more easily detect rifts within Gaian as well as other planes that can be used to travel. Other than that, I can... I'm trying to get into character with the sword.
Been a little while.
What's your motivation? What's my motivation? Is a sword.
It says I have been connected more thoroughly with the void. I can sense its energies when they are near, and I also might be able to help you avoid damage from the void. Void energies in particular. You or your traveler. I guess either is fine.
Or my traveler?
Yes, you or the other one. Whoever whoever decides to steer things.
Keep that quiet.
You know I'm speaking in your head, right?
Right. Right. Just for some reason, it feels like everyone can hear me. That was the weirdest thing.
Perhaps they can. Perhaps they can.
Anakin, who are you talking to?
Nobody.
All right.
I'm you saying all that out loud.
Just talking to herself.
Just talking to yourself, yeah.
She just suddenly hisses at the room, shh, keep that secret.
I am just so bored. I'm talking to myself now.
I want to go gamble again. What is this place?
That's right.
All right, so yeah, I can pass a day here. Let's see if anything happens. Is anyone doing anything in particular?
I'm going to go to the lab and start working on a tuning fork for this fortress.
All right. Do you already have that project mapped out? Like the requirements for it? Like, did I give you like how long that takes and the resources?
I believe that you told me that it was just going to be like the as written crafting a magic item, but the value is just the 250 GP listed by the spell description.
Do you have materials to craft that?
Interesting. I don't know. Do we need something in particular?
Don't know. Let me think about that for a moment.
Okay. You told me that I would be able to do it in the labs, but we didn't actually talk about materials.
I kind of remember that. So the project, 250. Generally, crafting, I think, is like 50 gold a week for non-magic stuff. This is technically magical. So, yeah, I mean, all right, I'll say it'll take you 5 days with a, just a 250 GP investment for 250 of components.
Sure.
So if you want to create that project now, you can just spend the resources and put it in the list, and then you can just put days towards it.
Because I'm not arcane, but is there any way I can help them to make that faster?
No, the good thing about this, though, is I don't think since this is technically not a magical item, I don't think you need the lab to work on it.
Oh, I did.
Nice.
Yeah.
Do you need me to subtract that, Sim, or are you taking it from your inventory?
I don't actually have enough on me, so.
Okay. Did you? Was it 250 Arcana?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yep.
And this was to make a tuning fork for what?
Here. This fortress, the sanctuary.
Oh, for this plane. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, I wasn't thinking about that as a project. Alright, so yeah, you can start that project if you want to put a day towards it.
Yep.
Yeah. Alright, anyone else doing anything in particular? You said you wanted to help him. I don't know. I forget the rules for helping someone with a project.
I don't know any magic either, so I don't know if I
can have smithing.
Could help on this.
Yeah, if you have smithing, you could probably help.
I do not. I have thieves' tools, playing cards, and cook's utensils.
Well, let's play some cards. So, Titus, what do you have that's worth any gold pieces on you?
I still have that 500 gold that Beryl gave me.
Oh my god! Actually, isn't Titus carrying? Who's carrying our bag of holes or our portable holes?
I also have the whole entire portable hole.
That's great. Now we're talking. Now we're talking.
Like reserve is.
But technically, all this stuff is yours already.
Well, do you two want to gamble?
Okay,
I mean, right up my alley. Just to kill time, yes.
Yeah.
All right.
But
so anyone else doing anything out of the ordinary? Like,
I have a question.
Yeah.
So Beryl previously spent 3 days at Aldrin's Watch working on Wyvern training, and Titus helped her for two of those days. And then now we have this trainer that's traveling with us and training.
Yeah.
Is there any benefit to Beryl spending her downtime working with the Wyvern as well?
Or, yeah, you can put it all towards the same project.
Okay.
So you can combine then those days.
I'll start counting Gazira's days, and I'll just keep on counting where I had Barrel.
Gazira, that's not how you pronounce my name.
I tried to write down what you said, Lou, and I have no idea if I spelled it right. So now I'm trying to pronounce it from my what I wrote, and I don't know.
Oh, did we settle on Loki's name?
It is Gahira.
Oh,
the J is silent.
J.
Gahira.
Gahira.
Yeah, I almost started giving an accent. But I realized it would sound the exact same as two of the other people in this group. As I was thinking of that Skyrim race. Khajiit. All right. So, yeah, if you have a project already, as long as you meet the requirements, you can put the downtime today towards it. Once time passes, of course. So, is anyone doing anything else besides a project? Besides, I know two of you are gambling, so I can get to you in a moment.
I mean, we don't have to actually gamble for money. It's fine.
It's a downtime fun.
We could just do dice rolls, or I can just skip it and say you just do it as non-rules. Alright, so you just play cards, not for actual money.
I'll just give him all of his money back when I'm done taking it off.
We can have
friends might be fighting words there.
We can have an off session, like online poker tournament, like just.
I was more thinking doing the gambling rules, except you roll against each other instead of against a random DC. Let's see. I think. You get to do three. I guess it would depend on the type of. Do you have any gambling abilities, Titus?
Yeah, that's why I said those.
Okay.
Playing card setting up.
He is actually my proficiency. A skilled card person.
All right, so both of you give me we'll just do it really quick. How much do you guys want to wager against each other?
Your call, Anakin.
I mean, I
think they're gonna have to wager favors. That's what they're.
I recently favors. Came into possession of several hundred gold pieces. I won't tell you how, but but you know, why don't we just we'll do small stakes. We'll just do 100 gold.
100 gold. All right. So there's three checks you both need to do: wisdom, insight, charisma, deception, and charisma intimidation. But you can agree. Both of you can agree to replace one of those with a gaming type.
I'm actually not proficient in any gaming tools.
Okay.
I haven't been raised in a monastery.
I'm screwed, though. She's just... everything wisdom related.
Yeah, sounds like you're both not that great at gambling. So do you want to replace any of those, or you just want to do those rolls?
I'd like to replace them with the card things. I have those.
All right, which one do you want to replace?
What were the options again?
Wisdom, insight, charisma, deception, and charisma, intimidation.
I guess.
And is
wisdom, insight, you said?
Yeah, and is Anna Kate okay with you replacing one of those? Because she'd have to roll it too.
I would have to roll. I would.
It would just be like Titus suggesting that one of the games that you play with the cards, right?
Yeah. Okay.
Like, he's like, let me show you this one.
I kind of assumed it would be my insight against his deception and vice versa. Is that not how it would work?
I was just thinking of making the rolls and whoever got higher would get the win for each roll.
Sweet. All right, fine. We'll switch with... What will I use with the toolkit? Intelligence?
Probably. I'd say intelligence or wisdom, your choice.
Oh, well, you're saying to a monk, intelligence or wisdom, your choice?
Yeah.
The monk's like, I think I'm going with wisdom.
Okay.
But, what am I using, though? Because I feel like...
same thing. With the gaming, it would be intelligence or wisdom, but you would get proficiency bonus because you're proficient.
But which of the checks are we dropping here? Because that's important.
That's up to Titus, because he has the set.
Well, I have a terrible insight wisdom. So.
All right.
Insight's out.
Son of a. I'm going to totally lose this.
All right. So give me first, give me a. I guess you would do your card check and he would do a wisdom check.
Fine.
Or she. Oh, not bad.
There you go.
I'm gonna lose this. Right. I'm gonna lose this so badly.
So Titus wins the first one. Now it would be charisma deception.
This is rigged.
Now do you? Okay.
Oh wow!
So look at this. This is rigged. Is
rolling hot.
This is rigged.
This is rigged.
Mannequin's luck is not great. All right, and then
The only other thing I could think of is you both roll deception and verse it against your insights.
Well, we just rolled deception.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah, just rolled deception. Now it's intimidation.
Yeah, now it'd be intimidation. Though at this point, I think Anakate already won.
Already lost.
Already lost.
Well, let's see.
Where the hell's intimidation?
Give me all my money back, you cheater! That's the intimidation.
And that
one's
it. Let's see what he does.
Oh, intimidation. All right, there we go.
Give me all my money back, you cheater. All
right. So, let's see. I guess, with more successes, Titus, you would have won the 100 gold over the day from the gambling.
Probably just gave it back after we were done.
Flurry of blows.
You just start punching. All right. So yeah, those guys are gambling. Anyone else doing anything besides your downtime stuff?
Can I help Sim with the key?
Can you what?
Yeah.
Can I help Sim with the tuning?
Yeah, sure. Do you you're Arcana based, so I'll say you.
Oh yeah. Oh, you're an artificer, yeah. Why am I crafting things?
I can also get any tool, so I can also do the smithing.
Yeah, right. So you could help him get that, maybe like the actual fork made today and start the enchanting process. So yeah, you can put a day towards that project. So the two of you both work on that, putting 2 days into it.
You have my thanks. This will be a useful tool to have.
All right, so the 8 hours would pass. Yeah.
Hi, this is Vlad's plan. Vlad is making bento boxes, as many as he can.
Oh my god.
Okay.
To travel with this, because he can't always make a campfire, so he's going to make bento boxes.
At some point when Beryl goes to the kitchen for lunch, like, she's going to see your bento boxes and just nonchalantly try to add, like, some of the treats she thinks should be in there with them.
Like worms and weird insects.
There's some some bits of tree bark. There's some mushrooms.
Right. I am going to definitely label these boxes.
So okay. you don't have to. I mean, you could just do that outside of your downtime project. But is that just what you're working on most of the day? Just cooking?
Yeah, I have nothing. There's nothing that Vlad is particularly working on as a project right now because I don't have a library here. So.
All right. So you mostly maybe arrange the kitchen and make these bento boxes and just hang out. All right, so time passes. It is now 6 p.m. You all can put your progress towards your projects. Now we're going into evening. So I'll keep passing time unless anyone's doing anything. Yes.
Do you wish to copy from my book? You look like you were very busy. This is why we're eating dinner. Sim, you were looking like you were very busy, but would you like to copy from my book? Because I think I have a complete list of the first level rituals. Did that know if you wanted to spend some time this evening comparing notes?
Perhaps another time. If you have a complete list, I do not... I have not been looking for anything that I feel I am missing. Perhaps when I am less preoccupied and
No problem. We will compare notes later. Yes, you do your thing.
I am sure I will have something that I could benefit from, but right now, especially since there are rather a lot of things that require arcane components right now that we are not able to do. So
no problem.
Right, and Gahira would talk about how well the Wyvern is doing. He's very impressed by the creature's progress, as it's one of the smarter ones he's seen. You should be proud of your little creature.
Beryl shows lots of teeth with her big smile.
It is getting a lot bigger. I've been feeding it a lot, and it's starting to get into the time period where it might be dangerous. So just be careful with any non-trained people being around it, like civilians, he says. It could tear someone's eyes out.
It's like 16 days old.
Yeah. Well, they become lethal pretty quick, he says.
Okay. All right.
They're, it's going from little hatchling to, child, and childs are dangerous.
Could we focus our training on, not scratching or biting unless Beryl or Gahira give a command or something? So is that kind of training, maybe?
He says, "Oh yeah, that's what I have been working on." He says, okay, "It's going to take a while, and just in that time period, it is very dangerous. So just be aware."
At some point during the day, Beryl comes to the kitchen and steals some oven mitts that they take back and use to resist some of the scratches.
Yeah,
I don't use those anyway. It's fine.
Old oven mitts. All right. Yeah, mage hand it. So the angels are still in the chapel. Corvin has probably been in there a good amount of the day as well. He probably came out maybe to say hi once or twice. But yeah, afternoon goes into evening, and you would rest. Yeah.
Yeah, Ufri, do you want to come with us when we go to the other realm, or are you still good here staying with Corvin and preparing?
Oh, that's me. Ufri says, I am willing to stay or go, whatever you think is best. I'm a little bit worried about going to Gaian. I have not been there before, and it might be interesting to see how the light and nature works there versus here. But I'm fine just staying here if you wish.
It's much better.
I am disinclined to bring him to Gaian until we are going somewhere that is less dangerous. And
we can't take you this trip. We are overbooked.
Indeed. Yeah, I can only carry myself and eight others with my spell. So.
Gotcha.
He says, I was actually thinking Corvin and I were talking about this, and we might go for a supply run to get some more supplies for the base. So it might be best if I stayed here and took care of this place for us.
Yes.
Or go ahead.
Silk. We need silk for the beds.
Oh my gosh.
Can,
no.
Yes.
We are not
Shadow,
running a brothel.
Oh my goodness.
Shadow cocoon silk beds. That's what that sounds amazing.
Says, yeah, I figured you'd want me to get more food and spices as well.
Well, yes, that too.
Alright. The prison area is still sealed off. I haven't had any issues with it. He says myself or Corbin.
We'll have to go and clear it out at some point, but yes, it will keep, hopefully.
So I might just need some money from the group before I go.
I believe Corvin still
we
has
left tons
a stock of pale coin. So
yeah, we left tons of pale coin.
All right, so I was just
take back to Gaian with this.
Please feel free to make reasonable purchases. I trust Corvin's judgment in this.
So rather than taking the coin from your vault, if you just want to do upkeeps while you're here, I'll just say that's put towards it. So, the aristocratic upkeep for each of you, the 10 gold pieces per day.
So, 60 gold for tonight?
Yeah.
Okay, I'll take that.
Basically the forges, the labs, get food, basically all that stuff. So, okay. To basically keep the base running, like running a keep kind of thing.
Yeah.
All right.
If I don't get on some sort of journey soon, I'm going to lose my mind with these frilly little things we're doing. Way too nice of a living. I haven't slept on the ground.
Trust me, we will be deep, elbow deep in the shit soon. Don't worry.
Good.
All right. So, anything else for the evening? Any interactions or RP, or should I just pass time again?
Pass time.
Okay. not much can happen here. There are a few things. Luckily, nothing does, and it is now the 7th of winter at 9 a.m. You would all gain a good night's sleep, just do your upkeeps and everything, and yeah, it's morning time. What do you want to do?
Well, are we ready to go back to Gaian?
Yep, sounds like a plan.
All right, I'll keep this place maintained while we're gone, myself and Corvin.
Indeed. I'll grab the Gaian tuning fork, and this time I will... It's actually my first time teleporting or plane shifting not to a teleportation circle, so Sim will see how specific he can get. His attempted guidance for the spell is a relatively unobserved location within an hour's travel of the city of Daybreak. Don't want to make a huge scene if we can avoid it.
All right, so once again, you all stand around. Go ahead and cast the spell when you're ready.
Yeah. Oh, goodness.
Sim pages through his spell book. Where is it? Oh, there it is. All right, so you strike the tuning fork as you finish your chanting. Once again, everything gets kind of wobbly around you all, and a moment later, you are suddenly standing in a new location. Your eyes, it seems like it worked. Your eyes adjust for the blurriness as it's
we're right back in Taiwan.
much brighter. you are not in Tyvanus.
I just went near the token. It's still there.
it seems like you're in a forested area. Survival might tell you something about where you are.
I did not know how specific I could be, so I preferred not making a scene. If the spell worked as intended, we should be within an hour of travel. So... somewhere within an hour's travel, if spell worked, should be the city, town of Daybreak, which I believe was our destination.
Let me see something.
Was it Daybreak? Oh, that's where we're going to pick up that person.
Yeah, right. Then we're going to go to D'Zoric next, yeah.
It just says in or near the location. It doesn't say how far away. All right. So
interpretation of what the word near means.
Survival. Okay, Beryl. You think? You know what? I'm just gonna roll a d20.
Fun.
Oh, Beryl. You think you know where the group is, judging by the forest.
The air is much colder and the plants seem like northerly plants.
you think you're about a day's north of Daybreak in the forest area. So you're a little off base.
Yeah.
But not too far.
I'm not surprised that this is not that accurate. After all, it has no anchor, but this is what I could do.
Oh, Beryl.
Yes.
Make friends with the tree.
Oh, yes. Good idea. Beryl will pick out a nice, strong, like, mature tree, but that isn't too old. Like, looks like it's going to be there for hundreds of years more.
Ah, indeed. Now it will be easier to get around Gaian. Good thinking, Liz.
In fact, she might, like, actually do that with two or three trees in this area when we start journeying, just in case.
Remember, give them names. You should give them names.
I mean, I think she might probably follow that advice and do just that. I don't know what she would name them, though.
I keep throwing my dice at the table. All right.
Do you want to make us nervous with a clackety sound?
Oh, can you hear when I roll dice?
Sometimes. Yes.
Not every time, I don't think, but sometimes.
Okay.
Good to know.
So, as you're making friends with the tree, Beryl, you would hear footsteps quickly approaching the group.
Something comes.
I'm getting ready, drawing a weapon.
Yeah, I'm ready to fight.
Drawing my bow.
A moment later, a looks like some sort of ranger, a man with a green cloak, comes running into view. He stops as he's caught a little bit off guard by you all just kind of standing here in the woods. And he says, who are you? What are you doing here? Please, can you help me?
Help you? What help do you need?
Sure.
He moves a little bit more cautiously towards the group. You see he has studded leather armor, two blades, a sword at one side and a short sword on the other side of his belt, and scabbards, a bow on his back, arrows, and his green cloak has a symbol on it, which history might tell you something about.
If the help you require would put us at odds with the Hunters Guild, then I'm afraid we will have to turn you down. we are here seeking their favor.
Zalafay has that symbol.
quite the opposite, and Zalafay might chime in at this point and say, this man is actually in the Hunters Guild, if you want to say that, because you would recognize the symbol as being a Hunters Guild symbol.
Is he, though? Wearing the logo. Yeah.
I don't know. Do you want to say that?
Yeah.
All right.
Hunter's Guild, yes.
Ah, this is member of Hunter's Guild. I suppose it makes sense. This close to a city where Hunter's Guild operates from, forest should be well patrolled. What is it you need?
Yes. So you are desperate and look to be concerned. What's going on?
He says our outpost in the forest, it's been attacked by giants.
Giants?
Oh. All right. Point the witch.
Oh, giant. I just get all jittery and anxious.
No, it's not just one. There are quite a few.
Do it, guys.
Well, giants are a problem.
Too much talking, not enough pointy. Before. Let's go.
Even if we can play them.
Lead the way.
We should see what can be salvaged from outpost, even if it is lost. So take us there.
Because we were going to have to fight the giants anyway, is what I'm saying. So
I do not know if that is true, but we cannot leave an outpost.
They're giants in the way of the one of the gates.
That does not mean we have to fight them. In any case, let us go. Take us to a place where we can see this outpost.
He says, thank you. My name is Adrian, by the way. As your friend said, I am a member of the Hunters Guild. But there's not hundreds of giants. There were about 15 of them, I believe, when they were moving through the area. My outpost, where several of our people were stationed, was attacked. I managed to flee before I was trapped inside like the others.
Know about slaying 15 giants, but we might be able to effect a rescue. We have options for this sort of thing. Let's see what we can do.
He says they were
15 is not nearly enough for a fun.
Wait, let him finish talking. What were you saying?
He says there were and he starts kind of describing the giant. Nature knowledge might tell you something here. Zalafay, you are pretty sure he is describing hill giants, which are some of the dumber, lesser giants of the giant group.
This will not be hard.
But it sounds like they are being led by a fire giant.
One fire giant?
Yeah, and with a 24... You think, let me get you the info, because you would know quite a bit with that roll. You think it is no ordinary fire giant. It's something known as a dreadnought fire giant, which is kind of like an elite fire giant. It seems strange to you, because hill giants aren't usually... led by other giants. They're usually quite chaotic and more just loners like ogres or trolls. But that's what you get from what he's describing. I assume you tell this to the group.
Yes. Fire giants especially are very nasty, evil sorts. Anything they're up to, bad idea.
He nods. He says, I have no idea what they're doing here. We haven't seen this many giants outside the mountains for decades. The most our outpost has to deal with is usually some flooding, and maybe a bear wanders into the yard every now and then. This something's going on.
How far to outpost? Tell us while tribe walk.
He says, it's about an hour. I've been running for a while.
Take breath, but let us go in that direction.
He says, hey, I was...
Beryl, if you could shroud us with your sneaky magic, that would be wise.
Yes, Beryl can do this.
Do you want to do it now? Okay.
No, I'm going to wait 30 minutes, then I'll put it up.
So he says, as you're traveling, I was planning to just head back to Daybreak. I'm thinking our captain might want to know about this, but if we can save those rangers, then I would be very grateful for your help. Who are you all, by the way? You seem way too outfitted and armed to just be random woodgoer or wanderers in the woods.
In other parts of
the world, we all look at Beryl. Beryl, go ahead and say it.
This is tribe.
Uh-huh. This is tribe.
I wasn't sure what you were going for there.
And then I'm going to do a minor illusion of confetti.
Oh.
We have some reputation as mercenaries further south of here.
Yes, I've heard of what happened at Issyk. You were one of the first groups there, along with the Blackwater men, weren't you?
Indeed.
Blackwater men run away. Tribe save some of the Blackwater men.
Who has cloak right now? That is likely to be useful in any kind of rescue we attempt.
The mountebank?
Yes, indeed.
That would be me.
And Titus still is with
us. I recently used it to escape from a situation in the capital city.
What were you asking?
But we've passed a night, so it should be recharged, right?
Exactly.
Good.
And Titus, you have the flying boots? That might also be useful.
Yeah, I do.
Very well, then.
So, yeah, as you get closer, he kind of talks to you a little bit about what he's heard about your group, about Issyk and Char, and that you all kind of vanished at one point. No one knew where you went. That you had teamed up with Asli's Avengers, which is another really famous group. So it seems like you guys have a bit of a reputation even here.
So when he thinks we're 20 or 30 minutes from the camp, because I assume we're going to slow down, so we might actually be closer than halfway, but like 30 minutes away, like I'll put up the spell. Yeah.
And if they've just like straight up overrun the outpost and are headed this way, we could be running into them. So yeah, it's a good idea.
So as you get closer, he said, you want him to tell you when you're a half hour away?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, he'll say, we're almost, we're about a half hour now, if you want to. All
right, I'll blanket the group with Pass Without Trace.
All right, so you cast Pass Without Trace. What does the spell look like? I'll let you guys customize your spells a little.
Yeah, she pulls out, like, a little sprig of mistletoe and some, like, needles from a spruce and a burned leaf and crushes them up and blows them into the wind and mutters something. Let's see. Does she mutter something? Yeah, and she makes signs with her hands. Or maybe the blowing was the somatic. I don't know.
All right, so you all start to blend in with your surroundings a bit.
And the sounds of the forest and of our footsteps just kind of dampen everything. Like, it just gets a little bit quieter.
Yeah. The ranger says, Pass Without Trace. I am very much aware of this spell. He gives you a nod of respect. Alright, so as you get closer, you would come out of some bushes over a hill, and you see a pretty beat-up cabin, which is partially collapsed in the distance. You don't see any giants, though.
Perhaps,
he says, doesn't look like they're here anymore.
Perhaps Adrian and Gahira and Wyvern conceal selves and stay at edge of clearing while tribe investigate.
Gahira nods. He says, I can maybe stay. I'll stay back here. That's fine.
Can you track them?
Me? Yes, I can try.
All right, so you approach the house. Yes, there are very obvious signs the giants came through here. From big muddy footprints to boulder-sized holes in the wall, or like large rock-sized hole where like they knocked part of the cabin over. Inside, you would see one pretty nasty-looking blood splotch. Looks like, other than that, not much going on inside here.
Any bodies, or did they take the bodies with them?
You don't see any bodies.
Maybe people still slaves.
Well, my biggest concern is to know whether they took the dead with them or whether they still live. It changes the urgency of situation rather a lot.
Baron's going to look for tracks.
We know the giants often take prisoners, and they are known to eat them. Giants do eat our people and others they capture.
Tribe should continue to follow. Yeah. Mm.
Okay.
All right.
I will dive in. Barrel.
Zalafane, by your assessment, how likely is it if we slay the leading fire giant that hill giants will flee? I do not know if we want to fight all of them.
I suspect not. Flee unless you can scare them also.
Hmm.
While they are dumb, still very violent.
Adrian, the people that were taken, good fighters?
I mean, they're skilled with bow and sword. They're not our best, but they were full rangers. They weren't trainees, if that's what you're asking.
But if freed, they will be able to defend themselves and get away, most likely.
Most likely, yes.
Okay.
If they still live.
I should keep tracking Barrel things.
Very well. Let us follow.
All right. So give me up to two of you can do survival here. I would also take a knowledge nature, but two rolls from whoever.
And I think
I'm guidancing the Shane guide. Barrel.
Okay.
So 24.
So, yeah, I mean, it's pretty obvious where these giants went. It looks like after destroying this place, they may have headed to the east of here, as there are several trees knocked over in that direction. So, not a hard track for you, that's for certain. So you start following them. And you still have the Pass Without Trace for another half hour, yes?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Okay.
That'll be useful.
So you're moving pretty quickly and quietly through the wooded area. What is the highest passive perception of the group?
Is it, I think it's Sim or Barrel? Well, I don't remember.
No, we both have Sentinel Shield, so I think you're rocking the higher one right now. I've 23. Got 21. Yeah.
Okay.
Okay. So you see a fairly large hill up ahead. Looks like there is a statue on top of it, like a ruined statue. And you think you see giants on the hill. You don't think they see you yet. You're still fairly far out.
Yeah, I'll point them out and lead, like, the party in a way to, like, kind of stay behind cover as we get closer.
All right, so you're moving towards them?
How do we wish
to... how far is far out?
Actually, at this point, since they are up on the hill, give me stealth checks. Because they do have an elevated position. They could, in theory, see you right now.
Is this including without a
plus 10? Yeah.
You gain plus 10. Yeah.
I didn't put my plus 10 on.
The 16, not the 7.
What? So that would be. That would actually be 29 for Barrel.
It's the
guidance roll. Yeah.
All right, so you are getting closer. Well, wait, so yeah, you don't think they've seen you yet. I don't think anyone rolled.
Rolls are pretty solid.
Yeah. So what do you want to do?
What is the range to the first one?
Oh, they're still like several hundred feet away. You're not even close yet.
Can we attempt to continue to get nearer as long as there's good cover?
Yeah. Do you want to keep going?
I'd like to, yes.
Yeah. Okay.
There's some question as to what our strategy is to be. Are we simply going to engage them and attempt to fight? That might be the best way to get the to secure the prisoners, but...
How many do we see?
So, from this distance, you see a couple. You only see one or two up on the hill, just kind of chilling up there. You don't see the 15 that were described, or 20.
So, as long as I've not seen...
How big is the statue, by the way?
The statue is very large. It looks like it might be dwarven. And it is probably about 20 feet tall.
Hmm. How tall is a giant?
Like, hill giants are like 12 to 15. Okay. So they're a little smaller than the statue.
As long as tribe should get closer and not make selves known right away in case there are more. But if tribe gets closer and not see sign of too many giants, tribe should surprise giants. This is Beryl's plan.
Sure, but how close can we get? That's the question.
Concern is that they are sentries or some such, and will have way of warning for the other giants nearby. But we shall see.
But all for horns? All the tracks seem to go towards the hill, so you think that the larger group is over there somewhere.
The ranger who was with this, do you recognize this area? Is there a better way to get here?
He says, well, there's two ways up that hill, the east and west sides. An old road goes through there from the Tharian Empire times. But I don't know if there's a good way. I mean, they are likely, well, not, I guess since we have the spell, we might be okay. But yeah, they would be likely to see us normally if we came up either road.
Do giants like to eat bears? Like, what animals do the giants eat in these woods?
They eat everything.
If a bear wandered across this clearing here that is in view of hill, would giants come down to kill bear?
He thinks. He says it's possible. I mean, it depends on what they're doing up there. Looks like they're just hanging out.
What if bear make lots of noise and act like it has hurt Paul?
He shrugs. So he says, yeah.
That's how tasty it looks.
Yeah. He says, oh, I guess there is another way. If we wanted to try to climb up the hill from the south, but that would be like a jagged like climb. If we, if everyone here is good at climbing, we could try to climb up and sneak up on them that way.
Good at climbing? Maybe not so much, but we have several ways to cheat.
He nods. Says, as for the bear, I couldn't tell you for sure, but I know they do eat pretty much everything.
What does Trav eat? Beryl can try to draw out as Beryl, but...
No. Let's not have you be the main focus of a bunch of rocks being flying through the air. That sounds like sucky.
Yeah, I think even with our
like to get in closer to that, which sounds horrible, but I think getting closer to the giants is actually a good thing.
Yeah, the hunter will say they can hurl rocks very, very long distance. So it would be dangerous to try to hit them from afar, especially with them in an elevated position.
Indeed.
I could use the cloak to get right in them. Me and Anakate.
I am happy to just stand back and shoot. Also, I can shoot from 600 feet away.
Holy shit.
Yeah.
Jesus.
Such a distance.
If we could go to the cliff, we could get into the back, set ourselves up, and then do the charge. How tall is the cliff?
He says, I believe it is about a 60-foot climb.
Oh, that's nothing. We could do that.
Yeah, as long as we kept out of their sight, if you could all climb up the back, that might be the most cover if we were trying to sneak up on them.
If you want to be stealthy, I have a movable rod and fancy rope, so 60 feet should not be too difficult for us.
I could also teleport anybody who doesn't think they can climb, because I probably am going to suck at that. It's 60 feet tall, so.
Oh, well. teleport anybody who wants to.
Oh. Well, then there you go.
One at a time.
One at a time? Oh, well, there you go. But yes, I think going up the cliff would give it a moment of surprise, and then we can go from there.
Surprise, then. If our intention is to attack them, I think the cliff is our best chance.
Alright, so you're going to attempt to climb up the cliff from the south side, sneaking up on them?
Yes.
Alright. So first I need stealth checks as you move around and through the forest, trying to keep out of view of them.
Bam! Glad that's what I used.
Pray.
More like,
I pray to my god the entire time I'm stealthing.
More like Ninja Kate. Well, I think 22 is your low roll so far.
Hang on, sorry guys, I had a mini emergency and I'm getting back to the computer now to roll.
No worries. 19. Yeah, so 19.
Although they all can't roll below 26, so.
Yeah, so you pretty much pass the first part. Your pass without trace very much paying off as you are sneaking up on this hill. Give me one moment to do some map stuff.
27.
Show off.
The nat 1 is a 27. Hilarious.
Yeah, I was thinking that nat 1 was a 26, but I was wrong. My nat 1 is a 27 with the pass without trace up.
All right, so now I need athletics checks to try to climb, unless people are flying or
so
something.
I'm going to ask Titus to anchor a immovable rod most of the way up the hill, and I'll attach my rope of climbing to it.
All right, so you fly up there.
I can just fly. I don't even have to.
Now, if you're going to fly up there to do the rod, I will need another stealth check, and you might want to bring Beryl with you for the pass.
All right, throw Beryl on my shoulder, and then...
Yeah.
Yep.
Piggyback.
Oh,
that's what I assume.
Wow.
18, yeah. Or does he have advantage?
18. No, disadvantage.
Okay.
Oh, 18.
All right.
That might not be good enough. We'll see. Ooh.
What, 18 on a hill giant? Yeah, it's... Oh, you're fine.
Oh, okay.
these things are not the brightest. But here, let me set the scene here. Okay.
Totally fine. I could fly when I rolled that athletic check. We have lots of boots.
They're handy. You do have to track the minutes spent. You don't usually run low, but especially on like a long delve or something, it can actually be an issue.
No, okay.
If you like go up the surface, you need to climb, like fly up or whatever, and then pretty much turn them off. Like, it's gonna take a long time to get through all those minutes.
Yeah. I'm just saying, like for a long delve where you can't get a couple of days off somewhere.
So you brought Beryl with you, right?
She's piggybacking.
Okay. So Sim.
And I think we probably left the rangers and the wyvern below somewhere safe.
Yeah, that's fine. Sim and Beryl, as you get to the top, this is what you see.
I think I don't need to come along if the hill is only 60 feet high. The rope of climbing can go up 50 feet and tie itself to the rod.
Oh, I thought I was on Titus. I thought I was on Titus because he was using the boots to climb.
Oh, yeah. Titus.
Yeah, Titus. Yeah, I think you grabbed the wrong icon.
Oh, okay.
Fine.
Yeah.
Beryl will peer back down at the party below and put up
that
seven fingers.
That is what you see.
So almost all of Beryl's fingers.
And it is daytime, so let me make sure there's light out. Yeah, there is. Okay.
Is this the statue?
Yeah, the statue is here.
Okay.
And, so you kind of peek over, put the rod. Luckily, none of them so far have noticed you.
Alright. So I'll stand real close to the edge to blanket as much area as possible with down the cliff with my pass without trace. And I'll also work on keeping my pass without trace, like, try and keep it off the giants themselves so they don't notice a difference.
Okay. So are you two flying back down after you attach the rope? Or are you just waiting here?
I think we're staying here, right?
Yeah, right under, like, right behind, like, the cliff, though, like, just below vision of the giants. We will wait.
Okay. So you're kind of in the bushes, waiting for everyone else to climb up?
Yeah.
I'll move aside a little bit from where they'll be peeking over, like, the edge, so that they
climb
unimpeded.
So there is a portion of the climb that you won't be within Beryl's field, those of you climbing up. So first, from each of you that's still down there, if you're climbing, I need an athletics and a stealth check as you're coming up.
Could I just, as they climb up, could I just... I'm silent flying, aren't I, for the most part?
You're sort of quiet. You can still make noise, like your armor's rattling around as you're flying.
Well, do you guys think it's a good idea if I just go like halfway and just like move up with you guys so you get the
plus 10? I think you being anchoring us at the top is good.
So you're anchored by the.
No, I meant like you're the boulder. Right. They'll attack first.
I was just trying to give you the
right. If we bring Beryl further down.
If Titus wants to carry Beryl back down a little ways, then
actually I will turn to the ranger and go. Do you have pass without trace?
He says no. I don't have any spells yet.
Vlad, do you want to get up top?
So, Titus, go ahead and carry Beryl back down like 20 or 30 feet. That way she blankets both above and below us.
That's what I was thinking.
So we can see them, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, you see them up there.
I can cover it.
If
it's a 60-foot climb, I can cover it with the radius. I just have to stay near the center.
All right, so go ahead and cast your spell. So you do a little chant. I don't see anything.
There it goes.
Wow. All right. So Vlad suddenly is warped. Wow. And would appear next to you.
I take out a crystal wand and I wave it.
Appear. Wow. All right. Anybody so else? Vlad is now standing on the side of the cliff, probably quickly ducking down into the bushes.
Yes, and then I will lean my head over, and I will, with the pass without trace, stealthily cast Vortex Warp on the cape.
So, pass without trace, it won't hide, well...
it makes the wind blow a little bit more, it just helps me be stealthy.
And just walk up a wall?
Why don't I just run up it?
Yeah, you're pretty sure if you cast a spell here, they will hear you.
You turn around to, like, cast your spell, and Anna Kate's already most of the way up the wall.
So, yeah, knowing how spells work, you don't think you could do it quietly with how close they are. Like, they'll probably hear you.
Oh. Does someone lift? I will just scoot my ass away.
Well, I can go back and climb this rope. Okay. Let's see.
All right, Sim, you're climbing.
Oh, wow. Advantage did not help much.
Yeah.
Ouch.
What if Sim, Beryl will, like, make a motion with the rope, like, tying it around herself, like,
so,
look down meaningfully at Sim.
Sim, give me a stealth check for that attempt. Okay, so you do remain quiet.
I have guidance for that.
But,
yes,
yeah, you do remain quiet, but you're like... Damn it, as you fail to climb on your first attempt.
I raise an eyebrow and I wave this wand. I'm like,
now that everyone's situated up top, can I just float down and pick up Sim too?
I'll just nod at Zelophane. That seems fine.
Warp him up.
Alright, you're going to warp Sim up there?
I thought that we would just...
But if you move, Titus, then the Pass Without Trace moves.
Yeah, but if they're situated, they should be all right. And I thought we just said if we cast a spell up here, they're going to hear it.
No, he's down. He's down below. Yeah, he's below.
Okay.
Wow. All right. So Sim, as he looks at you, suddenly bamfs, and is now up top.
Am I the last one now?
Aren't there six of you?
Walking up the cliff.
Oh.
I ran up. I scrambled
up. Give me a stealth check, Anna Kate.
Okay. Do I still have...
You would not have the plus 10, no.
Oh, gosh.
Oh, why not?
Right, you're fine.
Yeah, I only get a 27.
Why wouldn't you get the plus 10?
There's a, because the 20 feet, unless you're going up and down with everyone, there's going to be a point during the climb when she's not in the.
Yeah, I it's 60 said, feet. Yeah,
well, I know. That's why I had Titus carry me to the 30 foot mark, because it's a 30 foot radius, but yeah, that's fine.
Yeah, but even so, like, you know, once she's at 50 feet, there's a point where, unless you're on everyone's back as they come up, then, yeah.
Okay, well, I'm definitely, if it doesn't cover everything, I'm covering the top and so it might be the beginning that isn't covered, yeah.
And Zala, you're going to warp yourself up as well?
No, it's only other people.
I will message Zalafoy, because it's a whisper, and be like, tie the rope around you. And we will pull you up.
I look at the rope. Like, I look at them.
Seems sturdy.
And I'll cast fly.
All right. So you're like, screw that. Casting fly on yourself. Go ahead and give me a stealth check.
Stealth check. Before we go. You're
trying to fly up quietly.
Go ahead and have it in there.
Man, that's hilarious. Stealth.
Ooh. All right. So, as you are,
I'm just gonna guidance myself. I don't have my sheet. Let's see.
Oh, you can't fly in guidance because it's a concentration.
Are they both concentration?
Yep. Yeah.
Concentration? Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, no, never mind.
So you come flying up. As you do, this guy over here starts looking in this direction. He says, He says something in giant and pokes this guy, who then is now also looking in this direction. But
what does he say?
Zala comes flying up. He would say, animal over there, I think. And he says, I heard something. And he's going to start walking this way.
I can use Mage Hand at 60-foot range without any components, so I might just use it to, like, rattle the grass over here.
Give me a... Doesn't that require chanting, though?
Nope. I have the feat that lets me do it without any verbal or somatic components.
Alright. Give me a deception check.
Try it. Let's see.
Since he's approaching, you kind of go, weep.
I'm not that good at these.
Ooh.
Just so I know, on size scale, are these guys considered larger? Or
large, yeah.
Large? Okay.
Wait. No, they're huge. Sorry, they're huge.
Okay.
So he kind of looks back over here, then he kind of looks in this direction, back towards you, seeming kind of confused. He says, something over there in giant. And this one kind of walks over this way and just pulls a bush right out of the ground and looks at the ground. And is like, huh? No. He looks back. He says, who there? Someone there? Maybe rabbit? No, sound too big to be rabbit. What do you want to do? He's looking around cautiously now. You hear from down below, one of them yells, what going on? He says, don't know. And do you all want to do anything or wait?
Not mentioning the kills.
Yeah, it's a lot of them, but I guess Beryl will just look around. She sees like Titus kind of like, just like poised on the ball of his feet, ready to go.
Yeah, this one's going to start walking in this direction.
I'm just waiting for the word.
We got it. The word is shoot.
Push.
Yeah. He pulls
I'm going to reach out and touch Anakate's quiver and put flame arrow on it.
All right. So you're casting flame arrow?
I think we're going to start our surprise round now.
Am I considered hidden?
Three of these guys aren't going to be surprised, but the rest would be. But yeah, if you want to start off with a flame arrow barrel, I'll say you cast that.
I assumed that would be that it wouldn't go off until initiative, or do I get
If you want to say that you're doing that, I'll say that starts things, so I'll give you that for free as initiative begins. So you cast flame arrow, and it would definitely hear the chanting, so roll for initiative.
Hope that was okay, guys. I wasn't intending to like.
So several.
I assumed it would be initiative. Yeah.
Several. Several of them will be surprised, but not
quick
all
question.
Of them.
I didn't click my guy. Do you want me to re-roll or stick with that?
Yeah, just re-roll.
Come on.
I'm gonna also use ambush.
So. Is that one of your points?
Yep.
Okay. So you.
That is not a good initiative. Oh well.
All right.
I'll link it if you'd like.
Yeah. Always. Go ahead. Always link it.
I burn up a superiority die and okay. To my initiative roll, which makes it a 19.4, I believe.
All right, so
0.14.
Oh, so I think you beat Zalafay then. Go ahead and change your initiative, and I'll move you up to 19. So you act first. What do you want to do? As this thing is basically, he's kind of walking towards where you are in the bushes, and Beryl starts chanting, and he just like his ear zooms towards like where the sound is, and he's like, "Who's there?"
I want to get right within. Oh, they probably have the same range as me, don't they?
yeah, it looks like they have a pretty long reach.
Maybe longer than this.
He pulls a large tree trunk off of his belt. And yeah, it looks like he has a reach of 10.
I don't think the turn order got sorted right, because a bunch of the giants are above the rest of our rolls.
You may have rolled after then. Let me resort. All right, there.
I already moved 5 feet.
Oh, wow. Thank goodness most of the giants are slow.
Right.
All right. So you come jumping out of the bushes. He kind of knew you were there, so he's not surprised, but he roars in anger. Squish!
I'm just going to launch into attacking. I'm going to use my halberd with Great Weapon Master.
Okay.
That's
12, no, actually that would just miss him. He doesn't have good armor, but 12 is too low.
There we go.
13 would strike with the second attack. Oh, I need a damage roll for the 13. Alright, so you cut him for 21 as he staggers back. Ow! And 16 will strike with the third attack, doing another 20.
With that, I'm gonna wait for now, and then I'm just gonna go with my pommel strike.
Oof.
Yeah.
All right, 24 will strike him as you spin the weapon around, doing another 18, and that will wound him.
Right, and then I am gonna take the risk of getting hit, and I'm gonna step back, right out of range.
I think you're still in range.
You're still in his range, yeah.
Oh. Is this out of range?
Nope, still in his range.
I think it was 10 feet.
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, am I within 5 feet of him then?
Yeah, right now you are.
Oh, I was just trying to get within 10 feet. I thought that was 10 feet.
Oh, this is 10 feet. Yeah.
Circular. Yeah.
All right.
So, like, this would be out of range. All right, well, now you're out of range.
Well, I'm just trying to figure it out. Yeah, I want to be in front of my friends, but...
There's no place between us where you are out of his range.
Well, then I am not going to move. Yeah. I just wanted to be able to get my opportunity.
You're good where you are.
All right. Zalafay, what are you going to do?
Or my reaction attack, sorry.
Mark yourself as holding your two weapons, by the way. Or two-handed.
All right.
But yeah, Zalafay, what do you want to do? Oh, and just, sorry, real quick, this is a higher point. This is about a 20-foot drop down to this cliff, and this is about another 30-foot drop down to this road down here.
So we high?
Yeah, so you're at the highest point right now.
Okay.
Yeah, we're 60 feet up.
Okay, I'll, for now, now I shall firebolt close one.
At the one that was just attacked?
Yes. Do that.
Woo!
Yeah, 28 would definitely strike him.
If it doesn't, I'm very concerned.
26 damage.
Nice.
Alright, so he is burned by a firebolt, scorching his chest hair pretty good. And he's looking badly wounded now. Ugh. Anything else? Okay, and just FYI, the bushes are difficult terrain. So where you are is kind of all difficult.
Okay.
The giant down below is surprised, so he's kind of like scrambling to figure out what's going on. Beryl. All
right, so this, I know that you said that this is the edge of a cliff here, along here. No. How does it continue, like, over here?
It goes out this way, so this is all, like, you could walk anywhere in here.
Okay, I could. All right. Yeah. And is this difficult? Is it difficult terrain?
Yes. Xylophane, were you doing something else?
Just doing Shillelagh.
Shillelagh? All right. All right. So, yeah, you light up your staff with energy. So, Beryl, you're moving that way. The cliff is behind you.
Yeah, if it's difficult terrain, then I can't get much further than that without dashing, I think. So I'll go ahead and dash and go to the edge. Maybe right here. And look down, and I am going to cast. So we have a 20-foot radius. Here it is.
Oh, sorry. Oh, shit.
Let's see here. This spell effect is 20 by 20, and then it's 40 feet high. So I think I can get the ones above.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Wait, what are you casting?
I was in the list with the tokens, so I pulled that out first. Let me get back to my spell.
You dashed as a bonus action, I assume.
Correct. That was my cunning action, yeah.
All right, so you drop an ice storm on the area below as a bunch of, what would it look like?
It's hail of huge, like, ice rocks. Like, probably like the boulders they like to throw.
Okay.
Except these are ice.
So, yeah, there's a bunch of ice that comes crashing down on them. Go ahead and give me a damage roll.
So I think it's a dex save, and then it's...
Went 16, yeah.
2d8
plus 46.
Yeah. Okay.
Hopefully they don't have resistance to cold, because that would suck.
Well, since these guys are hill giants, like, I'm sure that... Oh, well, I don't know. The fire giant, right. Like, might actually...
So this one takes 26. Second guy... Dex save. Bell takes 26.
Apparently hill giants are not the most dexterous.
I was hoping.
Very dexterous build. Look at that.
They look so alive.
Synaptic static, because I bet they're really dumb too.
You guys are really knocking the dad bod, alright?
I don't think it's the bod, I think it's the facial expression.
Alright, so they're all just kind of taken completely off guard as a bunch of ice smashes into them.
And that all stays difficult terrain until the end of my next turn. That's all I got.
Alright, Anakate.
Right, so did you say that we are hidden?
Right now you are hidden, yeah. Some of you are.
Alright, I will fire a flaming arrow... at this one.
Alright, so you pop up.
It will be sharpshooter.
Okay.
And it's with Vile Song.
Well, unfortunately, both of those would miss as you kind of miscalculate the shot popping out a little too quick. It just flies past him this way.
All right, my second shot on the same guy.
Okay.
Come on.
No advantage. Yeah. But right, a crit.
So, yeah, so I'm going to use a key point for... No, I don't really need to. He's wounded. Well, yeah. Why not? I just want to see what I can roll up here. Now that I have flame arrows, too.
Yeah, so that's 2d6 just from the flame arrows.
And I will make it a... sure. I'll make it a grasping arrow. I just want to see what I can do.
Oh, my God. Big number.
So here is the...
It's Alpha Strike right there. Oh, Jesus.
Yeah.
All right, so that's the Kinsei, the Sharpshooter, the Death Strike, the Sneak Attack, and the Flame Arrows.
Wait, 35. Sneak Attack? You're taking rogue levels? Oh, 45. Shit.
Oh, I guess the secret is out.
51.
All right. Now, is that all the same damage type? I mean, I guess it doesn't matter because he doesn't...
No, there's some fire in there. The Flame Arrows are fire, so it's 4 points of fire damage.
The ones that are different damage types, could you separate those out of there? I mean, it doesn't matter for this guy, but just for future. So this guy's dead.
Oh, yeah.
You just shoot him right in the esophagus.
And I would not have used an arcane shot.
So he's like on fire and he's sizzling with acid and he's like pierced through the brain.
But anything that's like a different damage type, just make sure it's separated out so I know. But yeah, anything else for you?
How do I do that? Sorry, I'll figure it out.
You just want to change it rather than, because those are all global modifiers, right?
Yeah.
So just change those to like just macros. Or if you add them to the bow or something.
Just click the global modifiers separately. Oh, like don't enable them, just click on them. And they'll...
You can do that too, yeah. Instead of enabling them, just clicking them.
Yeah.
I see, okay.
Just because, I mean, for these it doesn't matter because they don't have resistances, spoiler alert, but for other things...
It wouldn't have rolled it twice if I did that, though, right?
Yeah, you could just click on it twice, though.
Then Lou has to do lots of math.
Twice the effort, Lou.
Well, fine. Then I have to do like five times the math where I go through and... Anyway, anything else for you? Fine.
Let's see. I mean, if that one's dead, I guess I'm going to move to pick up a new target.
Let's see you move.
Yeah, I mean, I would assume I can see this one.
From up here, you can see pretty much all of them. The ones farther below would have cover, but you can kind of see them still.
I have more cover.
Oh, well, then it doesn't matter. Anything else?
I am good right here.
All right, Vladimir.
Vladimir's like, those are some big boys, and I saw that you did a really good job with the fire. So, everyone pray. I'm going to put up a wall of fire.
Nice.
To obscure our location, so they can't see us directly.
Well, then we won't be able to see through it.
Yeah, I know. But okay. Vladimir is more worried about him taking a face of rock. Baseball rock. His back is to the edge of a cliff, so it's like...
All right, so go ahead and draw out where the wall of fire is going.
Sure. Do I just show you where I want it? Just...
So it's 20 feet high, 1 foot thick, and it can go up to 60 feet. So just draw... Hang on. Hold that thought for a second.
And the toasty side is to the upper right.
Yeah.
Okay. So there is suddenly a bunch of flames. Now, the only thing is if you run the fire down below over here, that's on lower ground than where you guys are. Because remember, that's 20 feet below.
Oh.
So they could see up.
They can see over it.
I'm sorry, Lou. I got confused. I can't actually do the spell because it'd break it up. so I can't do that.
Ignore liar. Liar.
All right. I got confused about the train. My apologies. My
All right, you got 30 seconds. What are you going to do? 10 seconds. Just kidding.
I'll throw a level 4 fireball. All
right, just on these poor guys.
Those four poor schmucks right there.
All
right,
so after getting hit in the head with a bunch of ice, a fireball comes flaming down. So go ahead and spend a fourth level spell.
Wait, just to keep theme, I'm going to transmute it to ice.
Ice ball, all right. Link the ability that you're doing that with. Metamagic. Nice. All right. So you spend a sorcery point as a explosion of cold goes off down below. And that's a dex save, fourth level spell, 30 points of damage. Okay. First one fails it, taking 30. Second one fails it, taking 30. Third one. Oh, he made it.
Matches. He
takes 15.
15.
And the fourth one fails it and takes 30. All right. Anything else?
I don't think I have anything else I can do from Jim.
All right, Sim.
Well, this one's getting some Eldritch Blasts.
Pew, pew, pew. Okay.
Do I roll with advantage?
Oh, question, because Lou. I hate to mention this, but does a wild magic effect go off?
Let's see. Oh, yeah, this is a real spell.
Yeah.
All right.
Let me get my table.
Oh, fun. This might change everything.
I mean, usually it's pretty silly, but...
Yeah, usually it's pretty occasionally it changes everything.
The fireballs extra happens.
Right, it could change what I decide to do on my turn, is what I meant.
Yes.
What level art was that? Fourth level?
It was four.
Give me a d10 roll. 8.
No whammies. No whammies.
Okay. So you feel something. You feel like something just appeared in your pocket.
That's not creepy.
Sim, what are you going to do?
Direction?
Is it moving?
No, I think it's the same thing. Just Eldritch Blasts with this one.
Okay, we'll get back to that. 29 strikes him. How much does he take from the first blast?
And 10 feet of pushing.
I forgot you could do that. Yeah. Oh, dude, that's a...
21 a strikes again for 15.
10 more feet of pushing.
He's going to stumble down to here. Let me give a roll for that. Athletics, he just kind of falls back and is now down below. Unfortunately, he would have full cover from another shot.
Don't they? Oh, interesting.
Because, he's down below now. Okay, but you could shoot.
Alright. I have to fire them simultaneously.
Yeah, you fire them simultaneously, I guess. Sure, so another...
Just 10.
Not 10. Okay.
And another 10 feet of movement.
That's true.
All right, anything else?
I'll move, because I don't feel like being exactly where I was when I fired that off. But I'll just move there. That is all for me.
All right, so the hill giant. What? This one was not surprised. It's going to climb up this way, moving 20 feet. From his back, he's going to pick up a rock. Let's see, he saw Anna Kate kill his buddy, so he's going to hurl it at her. 20. I think that just hit you. Anna Kate?
Anna Kate?
You're my call.
Yeah, sorry, that does hit me. There's nothing I can do to prevent it.
Alright. 17 bludgeoning as the rock just shatters off the side of your body. Luckily, not taking you out.
Is that all you got?
That is it for him. This guy is dead. This guy is gonna move up and around this way.
You said some of them were surprised, though, right?
Not the ones on that. The ones down below are.
Gotcha.
So he comes up behind his buddy.
Three are. These two are not.
Yeah.
That makes sense.
He is also going to throw it at Anakate.
Dude. Sure, why not?
Monk tank. Shad tank, right?
No.
Oh, no, I would throw it at the guy with the glowing eye.
Well, I didn't dodge because I didn't. Yeah,
yeah. It's just a bunch of rocks hitting you. She's not good at the dodging. Yep. 24 bludgeoning.
Oof.
It's another solid.
Okay, that hurt a little bit more.
Rock hit you. Down below, this guy is still surprised as he's getting pelted with a bunch of ice and cold. This guy back here is not surprised, and he was not happy at all. So he's going to come 5, 10. They don't have a climb speed, but as big as they are, climbing up these cliffs is not hard for them. Like, they would, I don't think they could fail it. So he's going to pick up a rock and throw it at you, Sim. Luckily, you do have light cover from the giant corpse.
Woo.
Oh, that's not going to help you unless you got something.
Nope.
All right, so a rock clips you, doing 27 damage.
Okay. Oh, also, everyone remember your temp HP.
Oh, yeah.
Y'all started the fight with 11.
Thank you.
That is it for him. This guy is surprised, and we're in a new round with Titus.
All right, I'm going to... hold on. Yep, I'm just going to move... Oh, wait, am I in rough terrain?
You are. You at least for fly. The first 10 feet, but yes.
Fly.
Yeah. You do have your flying.
You
can fly, you can fly, you can fly.
I only have 30 feet of movement, though, so it's all right.
Yeah, but I'm just saying, flying doesn't care as much about bushes on the
ground. Oh, no, if you get to here, you're within, you can hit him, because you have 10 foot range, right?
Yeah.
Right here, yeah. So I'm going to go right there.
Yeah. All right.
Because I keep getting confused because their icons look the wrong size, but they're huge. So.
No, they're just the rounded off corners. You just got to look at the edges and imagine them filling the whole 3 by
3 square. Yeah.
I mean, it's not like they're 15 feet in girth. They're not like huge blobs. They're just using that whole space to fight.
Just like we don't use a whole. We're not 5 feet. One, yeah. Our characters.
I've never met a human who is 5 feet cubed.
Yeah.
Titus's shoulder width is 5 feet. Yeah.
It's just a block of flesh. So,
sumo wrestler.
Yeah. So go ahead, Titus. You fly up, and I assume you're slashing. Yeah, 23 would strike him. Ugh. Cutting him for 21, which will wound him.
They're huge, right? So I can't use a pushing attack, can I?
No, you can't. They're too big.
No, I can't. Yeah, they're too big. All right, I'm going to keep going for now.
Yeah,
that would have been cool.
They probably weigh a couple of tons. Oh, yeah. Crit! Well,
crit's good. Crit's good.
27 will put him to badly wounded as you cut into him with that slash. 17 strikes again, doing 19, and that will bring him down.
Oh no! No one's gonna take your pommel strike.
I know. Push it. Damn it. I can't use that to attack in any other way, so that's...
Are you wounded enough to second wind? Probably not. I don't know if you got
hit. No, I haven't even been hit yet.
Alright.
Go off.
Alright, anything else?
Bonus attack, spit at the other giants. Bring it on!
Alright. Zalafe.
Just get stuck in my helmet.
Zalafe, what are you gonna do?
Yep, I'll move out of the bushes.
Okay.
Jason there, but don't look too far. I'll just firebolt the one that's straight.
This one. This one here?
Yes.
All right. You fire a firebolt at him. 20 will indeed strike him. Searing him with another firebolt for 15, is that right?
Yeah.
Yep. That was
not included right. The first roll.
Then bonus action.
Oh.
I'll just cast level 1 word on Kate.
Thank you.
Well, 11, all right. So this one down here, he's gonna do some climbing. 10, 20, 30, 40, getting up on the cliff here. He picks up a rock.
Oh.
He is gonna...
The ice storm area still difficult terrain?
Yeah, well, that's why you only mark 4 squares.
Okay, got it.
Yeah.
Got it.
Yeah. So, yeah, he just kind of hops up on there. And he is going to throw a rock.
Kate.
Oh, you are in range. All right, you do have cover, but he's going to hurl a rock up at you.
I just spit at the guy in the sand.
Oh, I think 24 is going to hit you.
Man, these guys are good at hitting rocks. Jesus.
And a lot of other things.
29 bludgeoning.
Is that at me?
I say, like,
that's at you.
Thrown weapon losers in
because you were the only one in range.
Yeah, 3D10, that's an amazing ranged weapon.
Giants in general hit like trucks.
Yeah.
So you were complaining about not needing healing? Well, there you go. It's 29 damage.
Look at that. Lou did you a favor. Isn't he nice?
He's such a smart guy.
Helping out.
80-10. That is a roll.
Plus 5. All right. So did you take the 29?
I'm doing it right now.
Okay. That is it for him. Barrel.
Well, it's 3d10 plus 5, but yeah, still, it is still a lot of damage. So I think Beryl's going to repeat the ice storm, but move it up 20 feet like that. And
I get those three
druids with their buckets of spells, whatever.
Yeah. All right, so more ice comes raining down from above.
I was
targeting
trying to position
those
some
three.
Other things, but that one just made better sense to use again. So.
All right,
let me find the spell here. Not
so you spend ice another. Storm. Fourth level spell, right?
Yep.
The first one fails. Second one. Second one fails. And the third one really fails.
Wow.
All right, so they all take 25 as more large chunks of ice come raining down on them.
And then I think
this one becomes wounded.
Oh, and they... Oh, I did use Ice Storm again. Okay. I was considering using Tidal Wave to try and knock them all over, but I guess I used Ice Storm again, so we're good. And I think
this
I will use my bonus action again.
Badly wounded.
Can I stay in full cover in this brush, or would they be able to see me?
Oh, they can see you now. You have cover from the brush, but it's not full cover.
Can I have cover behind this ugly man?
If you went inward on the hill, you'd get more cover. But you're on the edge right now.
All right, I'll cunning action dash.
Okay.
Over here. Yeah.
So you move 60 feet.
Yeah.
Now you have cover behind Anna Kate.
Not for long.
Not for long.
That's okay. I've got some brush and I've got a giant corpse. Maybe that'll give me some cover.
All right. Speaking of Anna Kate.
All right. First. It would be a shame to waste these flame arrows. So, first, a regular shot at this guy.
Oh.
That's far, far away.
Okay. Luckily, you ignore cover.
Yeah.
Yeah, 26 will strike him.
I will make that an arcane shot to do a grasping arrow.
Okay.
That's fun. So there's the damage from the shot, and then he takes 5 poison damage.
All right, so 15. Boy,
that's underwhelming after the last one.
Right?
Well, you do the fire damage?
So a bunch of...
The fire damage.
26 more.
Fire damage.
Yeah.
Okay, it's not rolling for me when I just... Oh, there it is.
Oh, yeah, just gotta click there. On the numbers, 20. Not the text, yeah.
All right.
Rainbow damage. 20's good. 20's solid.
So, he gets a bunch of barbs on him as you do grasping. Just remind me of that. Anything else?
Yep. And my second shot goes at the one that's badly wounded. This will be a sharpshooter.
Okay.
But I'm not hidden anymore, so it's not going to have sneak attack on it.
Nope. Well, it wouldn't anyway, because you use your sneak attack.
Well, that was a different round.
Oh, you didn't sneak attack the first one?
No, I'm not hidden.
Oh, I see.
But you get it on range, though, don't you? Whether you're hidden or not?
No,
the rules are the same.
You need advantage or someone to be engaged.
I thought you were hidden for some reason. But yeah, go ahead.
All right, so this is on the close one that's almost dead. 22.
Woo! Yeah, that will get him.
All right, so here is the damage roll.
Oh!
27.
Flame arrow.
Oh, sorry.
He goes down.
Damn.
There we go. God,
you guys hit pretty hard too.
And I will say that's a good idea, Beryl, and I'll sneak around, get some cover behind the corpse too.
Right. Vladimir.
If I get behind this guy,
I'll go all the way right here.
If I get behind this, is that light cover or?
Yeah, it would probably be light cover. Depends on who's throwing stuff at you. From down below.
Too,
yeah, you have the brush and the guy, so it'd probably be light to medium cover.
Okay.
So like +2, +3-ish.
I can get to there. Yeah. I'm gonna move up and use a dead body as as cover. Kind of morbid.
Did you want to check your pocket?
Oh, yeah. Object interaction, I'll pull it out.
So there is a mysterious looking ring in your pocket.
Uh-oh.
You married a giant.
Put it on. I know. No, I've already burnt my object interaction. I don't have a freebie to do that. I will... save it until next round.
All right, so you have it in your hand.
I have it in my hand. And I will instead, I'm going to Eldritch Blast.
All right, so you blast down at him.
He's only half cover, right? That level.
He has no cover from you right now because you have high ground.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. All right. 14. Yeah, those will all hit. Pew pew pew. Doing 10. 11, and that will drop him.
Yeah, he's gone flat.
So he goes falling off the cliff. Anything else?
Yeah.
You're out of time. What are you doing?
I'm going to blow my healing light, all of it, on Anna Kate.
Well, all right. So you heal Anna Kate. Sim.
13.
Okay. Well, I will step up a little bit first. 1, 2. That's good enough. And then I will just aggravate this poor giant again with 3 more Eldritch Blasts. I think those all hit through cover.
Which one are you shooting?
this one. I'm just gonna continue to aggravate this poor giant.
Yeah, no, those will hit him.
So
pew, pew, pew.
10 feet of push with each one.
So 28 damage will wound him. So he goes once again pushed back over the side, cursing.
And I'll spend a bonus action to shove Titus 5 feet closer to his prey. Yeah, get up there.
Wah.
Unless he wants to resist. But yeah.
No chance, thank you.
Alright.
That's all for me.
Alright, this guy is dead.
Dead.
The one behind him. So you have do you have the thing where when he enters your range you get an attack on him?
I do.
Alright, so he kinda sees you with your pole arm out. And he is just gonna throw another rock. Who's the one that hit him?
Did the hill giant just make a smart decision?
Well, I mean, if someone's holding a spear out in front of them,
yeah,
it's probably not going to rush it.
long enough to actually contend with their reach.
So I think all of the damage from that guy is from the fireball and the two ice storms.
Mm. Oh, was that Barrel?
Yeah.
Well, he probably wouldn't actually know it was Barrel.
That's true.
He's gonna... You look kind of like you're a caster, Vlad. He's gonna throw a boulder at you.
God damn it.
He doesn't charge me, and then he doesn't hit me?
11 hit points.
So yeah, he's looking at your spear out, and he just hurls a rock over your head, and when you turn around, it just like... clocks Vlad in the face. Oh, God! Come at me, and he just throws a rock right past you at your buddy.
You might hear a little laugh out of Titus.
Can I silvery barbs that?
I think you would have had to have said it before the damage roll. I know I probably could have given you some more time.
It's automatic. It shows the damage roll automatically, so I can't. I never have.
No, I have to click on it. But I thought you were taking it. Do you want a silvery barb? Sure, I guess I can re-roll that. So spend your reaction, spend a first level spell. 21.
Pretty good.
God damn it. It still hits.
Yeah.
Alright, so that would be 18 points of damage.
Okay, oh, by the way, I expended a first level spell.
Oh, right. That is a spell slot.
Yeah. So yeah, you mark yourself as using your reaction, and you take 18. This guy down here is dead. This one over, yeah.
Would that trigger wild magic? Is that spell he made?
Yep.
Oh,
it didn't happen every time.
Yeah, for that one, I'll say no. I'll say no for that one. Yeah, you just took the 18. So this guy is getting tired of Sim's crap. He's going to climb back up here and hurl a rock at you. Nope. He slips as he's climbing up and just goes flying wild. This one down here did not appreciate that arrow. Let's see. So he's going to go climbing. Wait, no. It's gonna go this way. It's 40. Oh, actually, he can't make that climb with all the difficult terrain. All right, he's gonna hurl a rock at disadvantage, long range, at Anna Kate.
Mm-hmm.
15. Yeah, not well, but I think 15 is gonna miss you.
No, that misses.
Especially with the cover. He's gonna go 40 feet. Up and around this way.
Take the long one.
Wait, is that the... Oh. Yeah. That's the one that's grappled, right? So he takes the slashing damage?
Oh, yeah, slashing arrow. Yeah.
Arrow. So how much would he take?
Oh, a whopping 3. But it does reduce his movement by a slight amount.
Okay.
10 feet. Right? 10 feet, I think. Yeah. Oh,
so then he's, back here. All right.
Hang on. Let me post that just to...
Yeah.
Yeah, reduced by 10 feet.
Titus, what are you going to do?
I'm going to step up to here. And then I'm gonna attack the guy who's a little wounded with Great Weapon Master.
Oh yeah.
Alright, this guy.
Yep.
Oh, a natural miss. Wow. What?
Shoot. Oh no.
Jeez, I'm gonna use precision strike on that.
Okay.
One? You need a 5. Hey, maybe, alright.
So you spend a precision dice.
Hey-o.
Yep, that will hit.
Nice. Oh, by nice. Doing so they have at least, let me see, a 15.
18. Ugh, and he is now badly wounded.
Give him my third one.
13 will just hit. 13
is
their
AC.
Oh, that does hit.
Yeah, they have low AC. Yeah.
Oh, is that? Okay, all right, cool.
That's the number.
All right, so that will take him down.
All right, nice. And then I will use my pommel strike on the other guy.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Finally, a target-rich environment for Titus.
All right, yeah, you thwack him on the hand with your pommel strike.
And then stop chucking rocks, you jerk.
As I'm doing it, I'm going to goading strike him.
Mm.
Oh, that, and then I roll a d10 on top of it.
Okay, so 23. That will wound this guy.
And then I'm going to take one step back.
That will give him a noppy.
Actually, it doesn't. He's still within range.
That's 15 feet, so that will give him a noppy if you step is there. It?
Yeah, two diagonals. Yep.
Oh, the diagonal. Sorry.
I know it's giving him an opportunity attack, but
all right.
I figure he's not going to hurl a rock from that short of a distance.
No, he's going to thwack at you. Whack! No, it swings over your head. Xylophane.
Okay. First things first. I'll etch a rune in the air. We'll do a mass healing word.
Wow.
Everybody gets back 13.
Ooh.
Oh, wow.
All right.
I am fully healed now. No need to heal me anymore. I'm good.
He healed you to full in the middle of a fight? That's amazing.
Good job!
Okay, I am also back to full.
Then I'll,
I'm very close to full.
Yeah.
Is he goaded? He is, right?
He's goaded, yeah.
Okay. I'll move up here and attack.
nice. Oh, man. Melee casters, I love them.
Kill still.
Is this it? I think this is it. Okay.
Yeah, 22 wow. will hit him.
Whoa. Okay.
I like the name.
Dude,
that's pretty good.
For 20...
21?
Yeah, 21. Yeah, 21. Alright. So he is very burned, but still up. Anything else?
That's it.
Oh, I forgot to put that. All right, the hill giant over here is dead. Beryl.
So I think I can only see one of the remaining giants. I don't know where the other one went. I'm going to call out to the rest of my group. Remember that Adrian say big dread fire giant also with trolls, so, or also with hill giants. So maybe, keep eye out for more.
I was going to say something real quick. On my turn, I'll to the guy I hit in giant, I'll say, where's your master? I must inform him of your weakness.
He says, I'm going to throw you off the cliff.
I can fly.
Frostbite? Oh, con. Yeah. Wow. Con, that's risque.
With only one of them,
or he just kind of scratches his ear as he's wondering what that strange sensation is.
Ooh. I didn't want to do any big spells when I can only see one of them. And then I'm gonna.
I have a feeling I just said a York peppermint.
Yeah. Woo. Tingly.
You're awful.
Anything else?
I'm gonna move over this way. Let's do a dash. 10, 20, 30. Over here, rush. All right, that's all.
All right, Anna Kate.
All right, I'll jump out to see all of the giants we're fighting. Oh, they're all dead. And I'll shoot at the one that's almost dead.
All right, the one that's looks like he's trying to pick up Xylophane.
Sure.
Put he's that like, down. I don't throw rocks no,
no.
more.
No.
Yeah, I'll throw Xylophane.
Like, he's like at leave a bar. It.
It's like, you I'm look like you weigh less than a boulder. I'll throw you.
I'm going to remember to bonus action Kinsey shot this time.
Okay.
And here comes, it's a sharpshooter shot.
And you get sneak attack.
16. That's gonna hit. Take that sneak attack this time.
All right.
Probably overkill.
So yeah, as he's going to grab Xylophane, he just gets an arrow to the face.
There is one coming the wrong way around the hill, I think.
Yeah, and so
behind the shadow of that pillar.
All right. So was this difficult terrain that I just moved through?
Probably. Yes, it would be.
Yeah.
30 feet. So I still have 15 feet. Is this difficult? I'm out.
No,
now,
it's
right?
not. Yeah.
All right, so I can move right here and see that guy.
Oh, you can? Wonderful.
He is actually down below. You wouldn't see him from there. Yeah. Because of the height difference.
You mean
closer to the edge. Yeah, that makes sense.
Well, then I'm just...
Can you ready your second shot?
I don't think you can ready a second, because ready is an entire action.
That's a partial, yeah. Okay.
Yeah.
So I will end my turn there and be frustrated.
You could shoot Titus. Go, Titus, okay. Go. Pew!
That's fair. All right, I'll take a shot at Titus.
I assume you're not actually taking a shot at Titus. Yeah. Where's my money? Vladimir.
The shot's already going. Here it is. 14. Did that hit you, Titus?
No, that would miss. I assume you're not actually shooting him.
I did, just for the hell of it. Shot it at his feet.
I mean, she subtracted an arrow.
All right, fair enough.
Was that a fire arrow?
It was a fire arrow.
All right, you got
I think
six
they're all fire
arrows.
I was going
to say, there's no way I'm going to use
no,
all.
No, there's a limit. There's only 12. She's shot six now.
Sim, what are you going to do?
Wait, what?
Or, sorry, Vladimir, what are you going to do?
Oh, okay. I'm going to put the ring on, and then I'm going to hold an action for when the next time I see a giant to Eldritch Blast it.
Okay. Readying, so you concentrate on a spell Sim.
Yeah, I want to get out of the shrubberies here, so I will go...
Shrubbery.
One thing.
Excuse me.
Two. I think that's actually as far as I can get.
You're climbing over the giant.
Yeah, he's jumping up on his
belly. Yeah.
That's as far as I can get. And then I will also ready an action to Eldritch Blast the next giant I see.
Alright, so you concentrate. That giant is dead. That one is dead.
Right.
This one is roaring angry, and he takes more damage because he's too dumb to do anything about the thing you put on him. Ow, 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 ow. I got a barb in my butt. How much does he take, Anakate? Are you there, Anakate?
Yeah, grasp that arrow.
Grass that. Maybe he stepped away. All right, so I think some reactions would go off as he comes around the corner here.
Yeah, if we've got line of sight, then.
You would.
Who wants to resolve first?
I mean, we should go in order of initiative.
Sim should go first, because he totally would have seen it before I would have.
Sure, go ahead, Sim.
All right.
Oh, it was 8 damage for the grasping arrow.
Ah, oh, there it is.
All right.
Where is
it? Was it 8?
So he took 8.
Sorry about that.
That would wound him, actually, with the grasping arrow. Sim, you take some shots. Two of those would hit.
Oh, sorry. Pew, pew. The 2 8s, then, not the 11. Right.
So that's 16. Ah, as he blasts him a couple times.
I'll pull it 10 feet closer.
Are you going to pull him?
Yep. Yep.
Oh.
I can do that one per turn too. I just don't often have a need to.
All right.
Yep.
Oh, are you pulling all three of them?
No, I can only pull
one. Or two. All right, so yeah, he's pulled up a bit. He's kind of confused, but fine with that. What about the other reaction? Yeah, all three. Well, yeah, all three of those would hit.
I do have a thing that ignores half cover.
Yeah, so all three of those would hit. Pew, pew, pew.
Would I be able to see him for a reaction attack?
What reaction attack?
I have that javelin of returning.
Did you ready an attack?
No, I didn't realize that that was... It doesn't have to matter for now, but is it something that I can do in general is more of what I'm concerned about?
I mean, if you have it in your hand, you can ready a throw, but you have to use your action to do that.
Not for this go-around, because I feel like that's crap. But in general, is it something that I can prep up if I have...
Ready an attack is an action.
Yes.
It takes up the whole round of action.
And then when you use your ready action, it uses your reaction. But yeah, okay. So you can ready to throw, or you can ready an attack.
Anyways, but
all right,
good enough.
So yeah, it uses
all right.
Your reaction.
And so this guy is looking pretty wounded now after all those hits. He is going to just roar angrily, continuing forward, and he's going to hurl a rock at Xelophane.
No!
No, flying past him. Titus.
All right, I am going to fly back into the air and move right into range for this guy, because 30 feet should bring me into range, right? Yeah.
Alright, and you fly over to him.
And then I will just attack with Weapon Master.
Alright. Yeah, 15 will strike, and that will bring him down.
Where's all the rest? I want my dang prisoners.
So, they have all been taken out. The group is safe. What do you want to do?
So do you think there's like a hidden gigantic door somewhere around here, or did we just go to the wrong place?
They might have missed. Let us look for tricks.
Yeah, that wasn't all. That wasn't 15. Plus, we didn't fight the big fire.
There yet. Must be headquarters or something somewhere where they take loot and prisoners, maybe.
I'm feeling pretty good. Oh. Does anybody need a rest?
Barrel look feels great. Barrel didn't get looked by Nasty Giant.
Like thing here, like the statue thing, is there like writing or something?
Am I free to move around at all?
You don't see any writing a voice says in your head.
A voice says in your head.
Hey, what?
When you look at the statue, there is some writing on it.
And do I hear that in my head too?
No, that one was me.
I look at it.
It looks like it is dwarven.
Okay, I speak of that.
So, history might tell you something about this statue, but the writing itself says, in memory of the fallen, in memory of the fallen and our great general Raphia. And you would know that this is a memorial to a battle that happened here between the Teruvian and Dwarven Empire, which I should know its name by now. The Teruvian and the Drogoth Empire. In the early days of the Emergence, there were a bunch of scuffles that happened in this woods, and this is a memorial to one of those scuffles. Looks like one of the Dwarven generals fell here, and this statue was erected to remember him. That was quite a while ago.
Can I loot the giant?
Yeah, sure. So you are searching the giants.
Loin claws the size of hammocks. That's all I'm saying.
The hill giants don't carry great stuff.
One of the giants seems to have a magical sword at its side.
All right.
A voice would say in your head, Vlad.
Someone said that.
What?
Oh wait, So I don't find it.
No, you just find a bunch of small bags on them, as you are searching them.
Wait, hold on a second. Are you covering? Are you making commentary? Is that what you are?
Are you speaking out loud?
Are you talking out loud or in your head?
Oh, I'm talking out loud.
The path seemed quiet as the adventurers looked around the small memorial you would hear in your head.
Oh my god, I know what this is! I have found it! I have wondered about this! There was a tale about this! Oh my gosh! Wait, Benro, come here. And the K2, anybody? Wait, no one else can hear it. Oh. So, I have found a ring of commentary.
A ring of commentary?
Does Vlad feel okay?
The best magical item I've ever heard.
I think you're insane.
Can I take it off?
Require a checkup.
You attempt to take it off, but it does not seem to want to be taken off. And actually, you would think it's not a good idea to take it off, because actually, like, you feel like you want to keep this on. Like, this is neat.
Okay. if only I could show you. Okay, so, this ring showed up out of nowhere. It's a thing. Sometimes it happens. Anyway, explanation is pointless. This is a ring of commentary. It comments upon everything you're doing as though you're in the middle of a story of some sort.
It think about how crazy Vlad acts right now?
He said in a verbose tone as he explained his actions to his party.
And very so, verbose, I'm just going to look around at the party and say, of all the crazy shit you guys do with all the crazy items we have, we're questioning the ring that talks. That's what we're doing.
I mean, Anakin has ring that talks, and Beryl has ring that talks, so I guess
it's Titus is true. Looting. You would hear in your
it
head.
It has like a sort of like commentary voice, like hard to explain, like a gentleman who maybe has like a deeper voice, sort of, who probably doesn't get enough sleep. Kind of sounds like that.
As you're explaining this, you think you hear noise from the east. The voice says in your head.
Oh, we might want to look to the east.
Do those of us with perception hear noises to the east?
Can I search what's in the small sacks that I found? Anything good?
Yeah, well, this is while you're searching the giants. This is happening. Right. So you're still in the process of getting all their stuff. They mostly have small pouches on them, so I'm just assuming you're grabbing those.
Can I begin gathering essences while he does that?
Yeah.
Do they have it?
Giants are magical creatures.
What the essence of giant is, technically.
It's very musky.
I'm discarding a little bit. Not a weapon and not food.
Just pluck some chest hair. Pluck. Give me a nature check to gather giant essence. And again, that's going to take a while.
I mean, yeah, I'll do it while they're doing these other things.
Okay.
I will walk else. To the east and start looking around.
Oh, I guess we're not real with it.
I think something might be coming from the east.
So you look over to the east. The road looks pretty clear. Perhaps you didn't hear what you thought you heard, a voice would say in your head.
Did anybody else perceive sounds, or did he just hear the commentary in his head that there's sound?
No, he just heard commentary in his head.
Okay.
So time is passing.
So confusing.
The ring of
Castletic. Yeah. Sharp ring. So time is passing. Is anyone doing anything else while they're searching and gathering essence? Or else I'm just going to pass some time.
We need to find the other giant with the ones that actually are carrying the people. So does the path continue on from here?
Yeah, can we continue tracking others of the giants? Since the ranger said he found like a dozen?
Yeah. So are you going to motion for him to come up the path and meet you up here?
I was going to, before Sim took the rope and immovable rod away, I was going to see if the party wanted them to come up.
Well, I mean, he can literally just, like, come up, like, the normal way, you know?
Oh, that's true, yeah.
Yeah, that's what I mean.
Just have to teleport him if he wants.
Yeah. Well, don't use extra spells in case we...
It's not.
Okay. Very magically grab him, float him up.
Yes, the artificers get this weird low-level free spell thing. It's very nice. High utility. It's awesome.
Oh. That doesn't cost you anything.
Really cool.
I have 10 uses of it every day.
That's amazing.
That's so cool.
Wow.
Yep.
All right. So. Let's see. So time is passing. Yeah, that's the nice thing about being a full artificer. They got some nice stuff. But Beryl, for your time gathering, you get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So there's 7 of them. So you'd get 2. Well, here, I'll just put it down. So you get some essence. Not sure what you're going to do with that. If you're going to keep it or give it to someone.
I mean, if anyone asks for it, then like, I'll give it to them. Otherwise, I'll just scoop it into a vial and toss it in the bag.
So Titus,
I hear there's some very interesting potions you can make with essence of a giant. So
yeah. I think, should we take their toenails?
Are we gonna
regret not having their toenails later, or can we use the essence for that?
I think it's a different game.
No, seriously, like, isn't there one of the hill giant or the giant strength potion has a giant's toenails?
Yeah, that's how Lou always narrated it.
Oh, okay.
The couple of potions of frost giant strength we've encountered had a frost giant toenail floating in the potion.
All right, yeah. So that's what you find searching them in their pouches.
Not their poop, someone else's poop.
All right.
They apparently have a dog, and they forgot to throw the stuff away.
Like a human leg or a goat leg?
Yeah, it looks like a human leg.
Oh, it's a live rabbit. Can we let the bunny go?
If you let it go, it will very quickly run away.
Apparently you're not letting it go. You're going to see the bag animals I'm just going to throw over my shoulder. The poop and push aside. The gold I throw it over my shoulder. The leg over the shoulder, the head over the shoulder, and you see me grab the rabbit, I look at it, and I stick it in my own bag.
Apparently, giant, or hill giant, is Titus's spirit animal, apparently.
Okay.
I think we're having rabbit stew.
It's like, these giants know what they're doing. I'm just going to put a bunch of stuff on bags and carry it around.
Does anyone grab that emerald, or do you want me to toss that in the bag as well?
You guys take it if you want.
So it's been about 10 minutes since the battle ended at this point. Things are still quiet, luckily.
I think this was just a stopover point.
Yeah, it's probably about 11 a.m. at this point. So Adrian comes up the hill. He says, geez, you guys are insane. 5 giants or 7 giants. That's very impressive.
Yes, we will recover your companions, and that is our hope.
This is now.
Can you help us search the area? They may have dropped off some of their giants here and moved on to another camp.
So yeah, he looks around, and you would actually find down below over here several crates that are stacked up there.
Oh,
they look like they have markings of some kind of. Well, actually, it would be history to know what these markings mean. They don't look giant, though. Titus wants a backup box.
Yes.
So you think these are dwarven clan markings, Alifay? With a 19, you don't remember the exact clan, but these might be stolen.
Oh.
Them from dwarves.
Stealing from doors, never wise.
If you say that, the Adrian will say, "Oh, I wonder if they're stolen from the nearby dwarven fort in the mountains. I mean, if they came from the west, that's probably where these came from."
What is the name of the fort in the mountains?
Are they?
It is.
Grimdor?
One moment. It is Grimdor. Thank you for remembering. Grimdor, he says. Fort Grimdor.
Are the crates like nailed shut? Like
yeah, they're sealed. Yeah. It looks barrel. Like yeah, they probably stole them from a caravan or something.
Barrel pulls a crowbar out of one of the bag of holding or out of the. If I guess you'd have to get it from Titus, but
what
like
are you, what are you doing to that poor rabbit?
You had the bag.
Titus is too busy torturing a rabbit.
Well, I think the heavy things are in the portable hole, but yeah, Beryl, if she could, would like retrieve a crowbar and try and open one of the crates.
All right, so you're gonna bust this crate open.
This is while people are talking. I don't even know if she's gonna be able to get it open.
with the crow, what's your strength?
Yeah, crowbar gives you advantage.
Six.
Well, maybe not. Give me a strength check. You might actually fail this.
If you bother me, I'll help you. I just wanted to feed the rabbit.
Well, yeah, you would see what she's doing. Yeah. She's just doing it like, while you guys are talking.
Sure. So you pop the crate open. Luckily, it's easier with the crowbar. And it looks like there are a bunch of supplies in here. This crate has clothing, which you can't imagine is of much use to giants. Lots of warm weather clothing. Or sorry, cold weather clothing, because it's, yeah, you're in cold weather.
Maybe.
Do you want to pop open another one?
Well, like, I would look around, like, if, like, Beryl thinks Tribe should move on, but soon, but maybe also valuable to see if anything in here magical or extra valuable.
How about we just shove it all into the hole and sort this out later?
Oh, true. We could probably carry quite a few crates in the hole, because all we have in there is like gold and gemstones right now and bars. Right. Not large size stuff.
We just have a fort of money and then we can just stack this all on top.
Can we put all the crates in the portable hole?
Yeah. Do you want to pop the hole open and put them in there?
Yeah.
Yeah.
How many crates did you say?
There are 6 crates.
Okay, I'll just mark that in the inventory for now so we don't forget it. Let us continue to track other giants in case Tribe can find the logging camp friends, or what was the camp that was
outpost. Hit? The outpost, the Hunter's outpost, Guild.
Yeah, the Hunter's Guild outpost friends.
Okay.
All right.
Indeed, rescuing prisoners is more valuable than slaughtering giants, although presumably we will end up doing both.
So you check around. That would be another. The tracks themselves are pretty easy to find. That would be a survival to track them.
I will guidance the crap out of Beryl.
Honestly, I don't think she needs it. I don't think you can fail this with how high your
range is. I have like one trick, man. I got one trick.
He's like, let
Eldritch Blast.
Let him do it.
Yeah. Your one trick is Eldritch Blast.
My trick is lots of cantrips. That's what I do.
All right. So, yeah, you begin following the trail heading east. It seems they broke off into two groups. One stayed here and one kept going east.
All right. We're following them.
Yep.
East.
All right.
So how long were we in this area? About 20 minutes, is that?
Yeah, sounds about right.
Yeah. Let's say 20, 25-ish minutes.
Our pass without trace is over with.
Yeah, that's gone.
Yeah, because I started concentrating on Flame Arrow. Yeah.
Yeah, that's been gone for a bit. All right, so it's getting to be afternoon as you start. Oh, yeah.
Flame Arrow does last an hour, so I'll go ahead and keep that up for now.
Okay, so yeah, that goes on the bow, or what is that? Just go on the ammunition?
It's on the quiver.
Okay.
It's on the quiver, but only up to 12 pieces, and she has shot 6.
Okay, so you got 6 more.
Yep.
All right.
As we walk, as though I knew we were going to run into trouble. We eat bento.
You're eating a bento box? Does that do anything?
No, it doesn't do anything. It's just rabbit.
just enjoying a nice meal as you walk. I know there is something that you can do with tools in the Well, no, there's a tools thing too in the new what's it called?
Oh, right.
In Tasha's, I think.
There's also the chef feet, but yeah.
No, but there's an actual thing that they added for all the different toolkits for mechanical bonuses.
Oh, I'll have to look at that.
I know, like, Cobbler gives you, like, you make your shoes better for overland travel so you don't get tired or something like that.
Yeah, it's... Yeah, there is something, but it's on a short rest.
Yeah, I think... Yeah, I think when you spend a short rest, it does something for the group with your food.
Yeah, anyone who rolls...
One extra hit point per hit die.
Exactly.
Yeah. Oh, that's nice.
All right.
That's a nice little freebie. I forgot all about
that, actually. So.
All right. Good to know for the future. So you are traveling.
I'm going to fasten a little rope around this rabbit's neck.
Poor thing.
It's falling us on a leash.
Look how you lead the rabbit around.
Poor.
Are you, so, like, you giving it a leash?
Yep.
All right.
God bless.
If you have to run, please drop that rope, because at the speed you run, you will kill that rabbit.
I'm not even holding the rope. I tied onto my belt.
Oh, poor baby.
Oh, it's dead.
It's one thing for us to decide that the rabbit is dinner. It's another thing for us to drag it along by its
murdering head. A bunch of humans is one thing, but killing an innocent bunny is just terrible.
That's
where we draw the line.
This is my
Farrell
rabbit.
And I have no qualms with eating the rabbit. It's just dragging it along.
This
by
quest
its
has gone off the rails.
We just keep it alive. Plump it up a good amount. She's gonna plump it up.
Keep our karma score even because we're rescuing people, but we torture an animal to do it. So
what's more humane? I keep it in a sack or I let it walk next to us. All right, I'm just trying to plump it up.
I mean, be more humane to let it go, but
I'm hungry. All right,
fine. Just put it put it in your backpack, be like a fire, be like a giant.
We can kill it and you can dress it and we can have Vlad put it in bag of holding to prepare later. But dragging it through woods is just unwise.
Oh, it is, all right? We gotta pump this some bitch up.
I'm just saying, if you bruise it, it's not as tasty.
I don't wanna hurt it. I wanna treat dragging it great, it through woods feed it well. And then I want to take it home and kill it. You guys are confusing things.
I hope we're walking as we have this conversation.
Yeah, we are walking.
Oh, yeah, you're walking.
Good.
Once we're back at the castle and it's all fat and juicy, then I'm gonna have Vlad butcher it and serve
can
it.
Can I, can I, like, look for mushrooms as we walk? Like, I'm not going to, like, go, like, take extra time and go off track and stuff. But Beryl would nab, like, moss and mushrooms.
Oh, yeah. No, there's a random chance you'll find stuff like that. But if you're not taking time to do it, then you can't,
No, it's more like mushroom hunting where over the full course of a hike I might have a handful of mushrooms, not like where I would spend a bunch of time in one place gathering a quantity.
Yeah.
Not enough to count as components.
But... It's more like replenishing the snacks that she always keeps in her pockets, not so much like rare herbs and components.
Of course, you see a slightly sad look on Vlad's face as you're looking for snacks because his bento wasn't good enough.
Oh.
The bento was delicious.
No, you would be. So here's the thing. Beryl is always looking for snacks. It's just we have been traveling in some kind of places with less scrumptious things. Now we're in a forest.
It's true. It's more scrumptious.
No. I understand. You do what you need to do for your favorite snacks. As I
she will offer you the choicest mushrooms that she finds for you to use in your next dish.
Excellent.
All right. And then she will munch on crickets in between gathering the mushrooms.
I'm gonna look Vlad in the eyes and say, "I'll let the bunny go right now." Don't pretend like I don't like your food, all right? That's just
No. You're fine. No, I have an excellent recipe for rabbit. It is pretty good.
this is for you as much as it is for me, all right?
Yes. No. I am supportive of the rabbit in general. Just try not to bruise it too much.
The rabbit is a bit now. The rabbit.
Rabbit.
Annotate Karth's chopsticks with her woodcarver's tools so she can eat the bento box properly.
Just take some branches and whittle them down.
Yes, he's very appreciative.
What all was in the bento box? Can you describe the culinary?
Oh my God. Do you want to describe the bento boxes? I can describe the bento boxes.
Yes, yes, please.
This is very, okay. Very important. Let's go.
It's very important. There's a bit of variation. For barrels, because of the stuff you were shoving into it, I rearranged the bento boxes so that yours has sauteed grubs.
Okay.
Over a teriyaki sauce.
Mm, nom, 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 nom.
So as you're walking through the forest, suddenly several giants will step out of the bushes.
Oh.
They look down at you with anger in their eyes. A voice in your head says,
"Some big bushes."
Oh,
oh, this is all in his head.
This is a curse for the whole party.
doing it like it's DM narrating, and we don't know it's in your head.
Yeah. Though more realistically, you do enter a new area, and the tracks would make you think the giants are close.
Oh, it should be quiet now.
How long did it take to get to here? Over an hour?
It's been about. Give me a survival check again. See how quickly you were going.
Is that from the party or just one person?
Whoever was tracking. Oh, wow. It's probably been about 45 minutes. So it is about 12 o'clock on the dot.
I was going to say, was that a nat 20? I didn't even know I could roll quite that.
No, it's a 19.
It's a 19.
Vera, how far off are we from the rest of the giants?
Vera, these tracks look very, very recent. How long do I think? How old do I think these tracks are?
You guess that the giants are very close now.
Beryl is going to put up Pass Without Trace.
I'll hand Titus a potion.
And she will finish off that last teriyaki grub. So that she can put the bento box away.
What is the potion, like a regular potion, or is it like a real?
It's a. It's just a buff before the fight. Take it.
Okay, we'll do. I'm gonna take my rope off my belt and tie it to the tree, and I'm gonna pet the rabbit on the head, and say, "All right, hops."
Oh, you know what? I would not put up Pass Without Trace. Wait, how long have we been traveling?
45 minutes.
45 minutes. The flame arrows.
I'm gonna keep the arrows then.
No, the flame arrows, they last an hour, right?
Yep, because she's got 15 minutes.
Up ahead.
Nope, because you did it at the beginning of the fight. It's been another 20 minutes while we were screwing around, and then 45 minutes we'll travel. The flame arrows are done.
Yeah,
it was
45
minutes.
Oh, all right, that's fine. All right,
up ahead of you, a large giant steps onto the edge of the hill as he kind of heard you guys coming.
I drink that potion.
He would yell over towards the group, "Who dares come towards our group? Who are you?"
At Beryl. I don't feel like talking.
He says in common.
So this happens before she gets the spell off, I assume? Or?
Yeah, this is kind of as you were approaching. He may have heard you coming down the area here.
I'll answer if no one else can.
He yells, "Identify yourselves."
How tall is the cliff?
This cliff is about 20 feet.
Can we just attack?
Yeah, I think we sure. Just open fire.
All right, roll for initiatives then.
I really wish Thornwhip had a longer range at this moment.
I would just yell, I'm your reckoning, bitch. Let's get this
going.
Oh
my God. Oh, that's a lousy rolls.
Wow. Oh, there's at least two fast. Guys, there's at least two frost giants, and I don't see what is Dreadnought.
That's not frost giants. Those
fire,
are
gotta fire, be Dreadnought fire, right here.
Fire, yeah.
Yeah, I think.
That's, no, I don't think that's not a Dreadnought.
You don't think so?
I don't think so.
Beryl doesn't know. We are at 8:30, so we might want to hold off on this battle.
8:30. That's right. You're different time. What? No. This is good. We started. We're set.
Yeah.
we're kind of fucked, but we're good.
I think I got a better chance of poking a lion in a pair of pork chop panties than messing with us. We got this,
all
right?
At least their rocks aren't AOE damage, because they could, like, pummel all of us right now the way we're gathered up.
Yeah,
that's true. It's true. So, yeah, let me do MVP votes, and then we will end here.
Oh, yeah.
Trying to think if anyone did any inspiration worthy stuff. All right, I got 5 votes.
I just want to see one. No, it's fun. I know.
It's fine. It's a. It's a tie between Titus and Beryl, so D20 rolls. And I am no longer giving story points for MVP, just inspiration if you don't have it.
Oh.
So story point for journal, inspiration for MVP.
Cool.
Beryl, you are the MVP, so if you weren't inspired, you are now.
I was already inspired.
All right.
That's kind of sad.
So was I, so...
Good game, everybody.
Yeah, good game, everyone.
Yeah, enjoyed it. Thanks, Lou.
I had fun. Thank you, guys. Thank you, Lou.
Continue it next time.
Thanks, guys.
I didn't get to describe everybody's bento box. For some